Tonight's honorary captains, Sergeant Stephen Newberry, U.S. Army retired, served 10 years in the Army Transportation Corps and as a gunner during his 3 years in combat. In 2006 to 2008, he was deployed with headquarters and headquarters company 3rd Corps Fort Hood to Camp Victory, Baghdad, Iraq. He returned to Iraq in 2010 through 2011 and served in Basra with Fort Riley's 1st Infantry Division, the Big Red One. He and his wife Jennifer call Robeline home. Tonight they are cheering on the Demons with their daughter and son-in-law Heather and Caleb Elliott. We are proud to introduce one of the newest officers in the United States Army, 2nd Lieutenant Taimata Lufa-Lamana, graduated from Northwestern's Leesville Fort Polk campus and received a Bachelor of Arts in Communication with a concentration in Mass Communication and a minor in Military Science. 2nd Lieutenant Lufa-Lamana hails from Honolulu, Hawaii, and is joined tonight by her father, Sergeant First Class Sifo Lufa-Lamana, her brother Roger, and friend Rainey Michelle. Escorting the honorary captains are Lieutenant Colonel Wendell Bender, Professor of Military Science, and Lieutenant Colonel Arthur Smalley, U.S. Army retired, Northwestern Demon Regiment Chief of Staff. Ladies and gentlemen, please join us in welcoming our honorary captains and thanking all servicemen and women for their service to our nation.
Tails. Sam Houston is called Tails. The call is Tails. Lieutenant, would you do the honors, please?
The coin is flipped.
And it is heads. You've won the toss, Northwestern.
So there you go. Northwestern wins the toss. Frank Boudreau says the Demons will defer their option to the second half, so the Demon defense will take to the field first.
Demons looks like this defensively. Zach Krolchik on one end, 6'4", 260, the senior from Conroe, Texas. In the middle, Jalen Sangster, 6'2", 265, the senior from Louisville, Mississippi. O'Shea Jackson, who's had a huge impact, the late transfer, 6'3", 255, junior transfer from Arlington, Texas. And on the end, Obi Ioma at that buck end position, 6'2", 224, senior from Grand Prairie, Texas. Middle linebacker is Blake Stevenson, 6'1", 212, the junior transfer from Deer Park, Texas. Weak side linebacker and leading tackler is Quindarius Whitley, 6'2", 211, the junior transfer from Inverness, Mississippi. The star safety in his second week at that position is Hayden Bourgeois, moving from free safety to star safety. Bourgeois, 5'11", 184, the sophomore from Crowley, Louisiana, leads the Demons and is second in the nation with 4 interceptions. Corners, the true freshman Shamar Bartholomew, 6'1", 185, out of New Orleans, and Rashawn Crony, 6'1", 168, the senior from Pahokee, Florida. Strong safety or rover in this particular defense is Ryan Reed, 6'1", 193, the junior from St. Francisville, Louisiana. And the free safety is Nick Ford, who's back after injury, 5'11", 201, the junior from DeSoto, Texas. That's what allowed Hayden Bourgeois to move up to the star safety. Quarterback for the Bearcats will be Ty Brock, making his third start in a row. 6'4", 210, the redshirt freshman from College Station, Texas. His tailback, Kyron Jackson, 5'8", 180, the sophomore from Fort Worth, Texas. The wide receivers, we mentioned Nathan Stewart and Davion Davis. Stewart, 6'1", 180, the junior from Dallas. Davis, 6'1", 185, the senior from Hutto, Texas. The slot receiver is Tyler Scott, 5'9", 180, the senior from Red Oak, Texas. Tight end is Woody Brandom, 6'5", 260, the junior from Corona, California. The line has taken a beating for Sam Houston. They're missing multiple all-conference players. Left tackle Matt Burrell, 6'3", 305, the junior from Woodbridge, Virginia. Left guard Colby Thomas, 6'2", 290, the sophomore from Manville, Texas. The center is the only one who started every game. Tristan Wendt, the senior from Schulenburg, Texas. The right guard is a preseason all-conference player, Eric David, the junior from Richmond, Texas. And the right tackle is Ty Barrett. He is a redshirt junior from Dallas, Texas. We are set to go. Austin Fendrick has it teed up. He will kick it high. It'll be fielded about 2 yards outside the end zone along the left side numbers, coming up across the 20, across the 25. And taken down is Jalen Harris. So we will see this offense led by Ty Brock, which has led the nation in total offense the last couple of years, but they're on their third offensive coordinator in as many years. When you have that kind of success offensively, it tends to lead to your coordinators moving on up. And so first-year offensive coordinator Ryan Carty is calling the shots today. Sam Houston wearing white on white with orange helmets, orange numbers and black trim. Demons wearing purple jersey tops and white pants. Brock from the shotgun, three receivers left, one right, straight drop. Pocket breaks down, throws to the deep middle. Great hands catch by Davion Davis near to midfield as that ball he just snagged out of the air on the deep crossing pattern up to the 47-yard line, a pickup of nearly 20.
These Sam receivers, they're very good, but they're not very fancy in their route running. Most of the time, they'll just run down the seam and stop and wait for the ball.
That was just a little quick dig route. Shotgun for Brock, straight drop. Looking across the middle, fires to his tight end. It is caught. It was actually the slot receiver, Tyler Scott, who made the grab for a gain of nearly 7. Sam moving quickly here. Two receivers right, one to the left. Brock from the shotgun. This play action, quick throw, pass again is caught, and a big hit by Ryan Reed on Tyler Scott. But Scott has the first down at the Demon 40-yard line. So Sam moving fast and having a lot of success already, moving from about the 25-yard line out to the Demon 40. Receivers, one to either side, tight end left, straight drop for Brock. This time pressure hit as he throws. It's intercepted! The freshman Shamar Bartholomew across the 40 and out near midfield. The true freshman from New Orleans comes up with his first interception of the year. The Demons now plus 8 in turnover margin.
Defensive coordinator Mike Lucas told me a few weeks ago that Bartholomew, who comes out of a very highly regarded high school program, is going to be very, very good. He was simply waiting for the football. It came right to him, and he made the most of it.
For Ty Brock, that is his third interception of the year, and Shamar Bartholomew picks it off. That for the Demons, their eighth pick as a team. Shelton Epler will lead the Demon offense, 6'1", 205. The junior transfer from Navasota, Texas, starts at his own 48. Three receivers right, one to the left. That's Jazz Ferguson. No safety over the top of him. It's press man coverage. See if they take a shot early. Epler drops, looks quickly left, throws it left, over the head of Jazz Ferguson, incomplete. The running back is Jared West, 5'10", 187, the junior from New Orleans. Receivers, the aforementioned Jazz Ferguson, 6'5", 220, junior from St. Francisville. Quan Short, 6'2", 195, the junior transfer from Humble, Texas. Jalen Watson, 6'1", 191, the senior from Los Angeles. And Bryson Bork, 5'11", 187, the senior from New Iberia. Three receivers right. They're going to throw the bubble screen to the outside. Good blocking in front for Quan Shorts. He hits the sideline and has the first down and a gain of nearly 12, but there is a flag down. This could be a holding violation against the Demon wide receiving core, and I think that's what we're going to see. The tight end for the Demons is Kalen Meggs, 6'1", 243, the
holding
senior.
Number 8, offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay second down.
So the Demons got a nice job on the bubble, but it was a little too good from Jalen Watson on the block. He gets called for the hold. Offensive line across the front looks like this. Jonathan Hubbard, the left tackle, 6'4", 292. He's a junior from Kilgore. Left guard Frank Boudreau, 6'4", 294, the senior from Murphy, Texas. Center Kenny Sheldon, 6'2", 281, the redshirt freshman from Houston, Texas. Parker Fink is at right guard, 6'3", 253, the redshirt freshman from Gina. Three receivers left, one to the right on second down and 18. Good pocket for Epler, deep middle pass. That one is grabbed by Jazz Ferguson down to the 35-yard line. A gain of 30 for Ferguson.
That was not an easy catch, Patrick. Jazz made it look easier than it really was.
And your right tackle is Dustin Burns, 6'4", 301, the junior from Beaumont, Texas. First and 10 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 35. Three receivers right, one left. First handoff of the ball game, Jared West gets a yard. Defensively for Sam Houston, they are a 4-2-5 type squad. The two ends are both very good. Derek Roberson, a senior from San Antonio, and Eric Fowler, a junior from Austin, Texas. In the middle, Sean Mustin, a junior from Fontana, California, and Osi Odume, a redshirt freshman from A-Leaf, Texas. The middle linebacker is Hunter Brown, a senior from Weston, Florida. Weak side linebacker Roy C., a junior from Shepherd, Texas. Three receivers right, one to the left. Quan Shorts in motion now to wide right. Epler in the shotgun, fakes the inside handoff, nowhere to go, rolls out to his left, now going to throw it long to Ferguson, it pops up in the air, and it's intercepted inside the 10-yard line. Finally, the tackle will be made on Zion McCollum, but we have a flag down. It was off of the hands of Jazz Ferguson, it was a broken play, Epler rolled out to his left, Ferguson took off down the field, and so...
After the interception, illegal block in the back. Number one on the return team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, Sam Houston.
So when Jazz Ferguson saw the scramble, he took off down the field. Epler threw it down the field, but underthrew Ferguson, who when he tried to go up and get it, kind of popped the ball up in the air, and Zion McCollum was able to pick it off.
Just a tough break is about the best way to describe that. I mean, it looked like Epler had led Ferguson, and he had his hands on the football, but could not secure it. And you're right, the ball just bounced into the DB's hands.
So that's the third interception of the year for Shelton Epler. He started with 11 touchdowns and no picks. Since then, no touchdowns and three interceptions. This will be an inside handoff over left tackle. That's that outside zone run for Kyron Jackson, who gets nearly 8 to the 20-yard line. So both teams have traded interceptions here, but both teams have come up empty. 12-12 left to go in the first quarter. No score. Two receivers to either side. Coming in, Sam Houston was minus 1 in turnover margin. They're back there now. Handoff up the middle. Huge running room for Jackson, who will get all the way out to the 40-yard line, just gashing the Demons right up the middle.
Northwestern was plus 8 in turnovers after the interception they made, and they gave it back.
Yeah, they were plus 8 just a minute ago, Tony. Two receivers to either side, balanced spread formation here. Brock calls for the football and drops, looking left. Now he's going to swing it out to his back out of the backfield, who has a ton of running room, and Jackson's got another first down across midfield to the Demon 49-yard line. Gain of 11 on the swing pass out of the backfield to Jackson, his 17th catch of the year. So two receivers to either side, first and 10 at the Demon 49. Play action inside, under pressure, rolls around. Brock throws to the sideline, wide open. First down yardage as he found his receiver on the far sideline. I believe that was Tyler Scott again. He was just hanging out. Should have been a sack for NSU. Instead, Brock got away from the tackle and then made the throw for a first down gain to the Demon 38, a gain of 11. The Demon's front four is getting to Brock, but they haven't gotten him down yet. This will be a inside zone handoff. Not much there. Damian Thompson, Blake Stevenson, Zach Krolchik, O'Shea Jackson all in there to help that stop, a gain of a yard.
Boy, O'Shea Jackson has put together some nice games lately, hasn't he?
21 tackles, leads the team with 5 tackles for loss, second on the team with a pair of sacks. Late transfer out of Trinity Valley. Running back goes in motion, trying to throw the screen. It's there, blockers in front, cutting it back up, and then back to the sideline again. That's the Bearcats' Jacoby Butler, senior running back, all the way down to the 26-yard line. So the Demons get victimized by the screen pass. And the Bearcats have it at the Demons 25. 10.5 left to go first quarter. Still no score. Two receivers either side. Inside handoff. Big running room there. Out to the right side before Ryan Reed will take down Jacoby Butler. That is a gain of nearly 5 to the Demon 21-yard line. Both of these teams want to move fast. The first couple of games of the year, Sam Houston wasn't running tempo as much. They were a much different-looking offense than Ty Brock came in. Now they're running a lot more tempo. Demon showing blitz off the edge, the right side of the offense. Here comes the blitz. Just a jump ball to the back of the end zone. It's incomplete out of the back. Nathan Stewart caught it, but he was out of the back of the end zone when he came down with it. You can see the streak mark from his foot about 3 yards behind the back end of the end zone.
If the end zone was 15 yards deep, that's a
touchdown. Yeah, that's an easy touchdown. That was just sort of a jump ball lob thrown to the back of the middle of the end zone. So now third down and a little less than five for Sam Houston at the Demon 20. They do have an a great kicker in Trey Hahnstein. Two receivers to either side. Demons, three down linemen showing blitz. They come. Quick throw to the outside. Caught. Tackle broken by Davion Davis, and he will score. Well, you needed Nick Ford to make that tackle. He did not. And Davion Davis was able to take it to the house from there from 20 yards. Demons brought the blitz. They got there, but Brock got it out of his hand a little bit faster than Hayden Bourgeois could get to him. And then it was just a matter of making the tackle one-on-one, and Davion Davis broke the tackle and took it the rest of the way for his fifth receiving touchdown of the year. And Sam Houston takes the early 6-0 lead here. Bearcats already 121 yards of offense. Extra point on the way from Hahnstein, the senior from Georgetown, Texas, and it is good. 9:52 left to go in the first quarter of play. It's now 7-0 Sam Houston. We'll take a break, come back with more after this on the Demon Sports Network.
At our south end zone, please check out our Super One first kick kid, Anna, as she attempts a kick into our end zone. And our Super One first kick kid.
Also, the Office of University Recruiting would like to welcome all of our Fall Inside U Day participants and thank them for coming out to support the NSU Demons.
Bank of Louisiana, your bank for life. Drive summary on that one. Sam Houston, 9 plays, 88 yards, took 2 minutes 35 seconds on the clock. Officially a 21-yard pass from Ty Brock to Davion Davis. For Brock, his fourth passing touchdown of the year. For Davis, his fifth receiving touchdown of the year. And the Sam Houston Bearcats lead early, 7-0. Turnovers by each team on their first possessions. Both teams were inside plus territory when they turned it over, but Tony, there again, we've seen now in the last 2 weeks, NSU has had the ball basically at midfield or inside of midfield 5 times in the last 2 weeks, and they've come up with a total of 3 points.
That's been the elephant in the room, so to speak, during the last two ball games, a two-game losing streak. And you hate to see the Demons start off that way offensively. Mike Lucas talking to his defense here on the sideline. He said a couple of things. Number one, the B gap is where Sam is having success running the football. The Demons have to fill that gap. And B, he said, who missed that tackle? Nick Ford raised his hand. Mike Lucas screamed, come on, man. He said, who missed that sack on the quarterback? Blake Stevenson, I believe, is the player who raised his hand. He said, come on, we've got our hands around them.
This ball will be fielded at the 2-yard line by Miles Ward up to the 15 to the 20. He gets across the 20 and 25, nearly to the 30-yard line goes Miles Ward, who sixth in the Southland Conference, averaging just over 23 yards per kickoff return, and had a good one to 50-plus yarder to set up the first drive for NSU against Nichols last week. Let's finish out the defense for Sam Houston. Their corners, Jalen Thomas, a sophomore from Houston, and we mentioned Zion McCollum, who got the interception off the tip ball, the sophomore from Galveston, Texas. The strong safety is a good one, Adrian Contreras. He's been there for a bit. Senior from Georgetown, Texas. The free safety, Daniel Adams, a junior from Jasper, Texas. First and 10 for the Demons at their own 30. Epler in the shotgun. Jazz Ferguson on the move. They're going to fake to him. Now give off inside. Good running room there. Bit of a crease and a gain of nearly five over left guard. And that's Stafford Anderson, 6'1", 210, the sophomore from Baton Rouge. By the way, Tony, you mentioned the B gap. That's a gain of four officially. The B gap, the A gap is between the center and the guard. The B gap is between the guard and the tackle. So that's where Sam Houston, according to Mike Lucas, having success running the football. Receiver right, two to the left. That's Quan Shorts and Jazz Ferguson. You got a tight end left and a tailback left. Epler looking to the sideline. Now Jazz Ferguson comes in quick motion. Little quick rollout left. Epler looking to the sideline. Now throws it late and incomplete wide of Quan Shorts. Shorts was picked up by the backup Bearcat linebacker, Evren Hawkins, a freshman from Angleton, Texas, and it's now third down and six for NSU. The Demons coming in 36% on third down conversions. That's seventh best in the Southland. Meanwhile, you're talking about the best third down defense in the league in Sam Houston. They give up just 28% third down conversions. This is the first third down for the Demons in this game. Bryson Bork across the formation to slot left. Quick look to him on the outside. Great catch, and he's got the first down across the 40. Was well covered on that play by the free safety, Daniel Adams. But it was just a simple motion across the formation. Jazz Ferguson ran deep, and Bork broke inside and out to the flat. Was able to get enough for the first down for Bork. Just his fifth catch of the year. First and 10 for the Demons at their own 41. Three receivers, triangle formation right. One left is Ferguson. No safety over the top of Jazz Ferguson either. They believe Zion McCollum can play him straight up. Zion McCollum, by the way, is 6'4". This will be an inside handoff, hit in the backfield and dropped in the backfield. Great penetration from the offensive left side. And no dice that time. It was Eric Fowler. We mentioned the two defensive ends for Sam Houston are so good. Both are transfers from Texas. Derek Roberson came in a few years ago. Eric Fowler came in recently. Both. Between them, 14 and a half tackles for loss and 7.5 sacks. Second and 13 now for the Demons at their own 38. Three receivers right, tight end left. Stafford Anderson out of the backfield in motion. They're going to throw the swing pass to him. Anderson, full head of steam. Great tackle by Adrian Contreras. And then a late flag comes flying in from our umpire. This looks like it might be a chop block against Northwestern State. You had two guys blocking one. And if one went low and one stayed high, it's a chop block.
Personal foul, chop block, number 73 and 75, offense, 15-yard penalty, replay second down.
That's Zach Perry and Dustin Burns who get called for the chop block combination. If one guy is up high, the other one cannot go low. And so that time, Zach Perry and Dustin Burns. Perry is playing right tackle right now. Dustin Burns is playing right guard. The Demons played just five offensive linemen last week. They had to play Iron Man football on the offensive line. Just five guys played, all told. So now the line of scrimmage is the 23. They need 28 to get a first down. Second and 28. Two receivers left, three to the right. Need to try to get at least half of it here. Epler, quick look, quick slant, caught by Jazz Ferguson, breaks one tackle. And then gets it across the 30 to the 33-yard line. So that's a pickup of 10. Still going to be long yardage to go. Third down and 18 for the Demons. Your officiating crew, Kevin Boytman, the head referee, David Williams, the umpire, Greg Downham, the head linesman, Carlos Owens, the line judge, Scotty Malanson, the field judge, Dave Kirschman, the side judge, and Michael Aronian, the back judge. Third and 18, three receivers right, two to the left, five receiver package, straight drop. Pressure for Epler, and he goes down in the backfield. Derek Roberson picks up his sixth sack of the year. He came in number two in the Southland Conference in sacks for the Demons. That is just their ninth sack allowed. Had given up just eight sacks coming in, second best in the Southland, but that time the tremendous defensive end, Derek Roberson, got right past his man. I think it was Zach Perry, and got right to Epler.
Is it J.P. Hall that was so good
PJ
for
Hall.
Sam? I'm sorry, P.J. Hall.
Yeah.
Thank goodness he's gone.
Now in the NFL with the Oakland Raiders. Fourth and a mile for NSU back at their own 28. They'll punt it away. Parker Pastorello gets away a beautiful driving spiral. Fielded at the 25-yard line. Davion Davis gets away from the initial wave. Goes up the middle of the field and is out to the 45-yard line. So a terrific punt by Pastorello, but a bit of a out-puncher coverage there. And Davion Davis, one of the best return men in the game, gives Sam Houston tremendous field position when we return. 6:14 left to go in the first quarter. Sam leads 7-0. They have the ball back when we return on the Demon Sports Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the 25-yard line for a special presentation to our game day title sponsors, Atmos Energy, the Louisiana Lottery, and Frog Pond Apartments. The strong sponsor support of these dedicated partners is vital to the success of NSU Athletics. Let's give our game day title sponsors a big demon round of applause.
In Winfield, Northwestern State trails 7-0 as Sam Houston goes back on offense. The Demons victimized by a chop block penalty. And so far have run the ball 4 times for minus 3 yards. Of course, that sack is included in that rushing yardage. First and 10 for Sam. Quick look to the right, throw over the middle. Davion Davis with another terrific catch, and he will get the first down at the Demon 42-yard line. And the problem right now is Ty Brock's not holding on to the football at all. It is coming out with some quickness, and that makes it very difficult to put any pressure on the guy when he's throwing it so fast. First and 10 at the Demon 42. Claps for the football. Outside zone around right tackle. Cutting it up is Kyron Jackson, and he'll get 7.
Patrick.
Sam Houston averaging nearly 10 yards a play right now, Tony.
During that timeout, Northwestern State offensive coordinator Brad Smiley called his offense together. He does not normally do that, and in layman's terms, he read them the riot act.
Quick throw to the outside. Pass is caught by Nathan Stewart. He'll cut it up the middle and down to the Demon 25-yard line. That's a pickup of 10.
Brad Smiley's basic message was is that we're hurting ourselves, and he preached discipline, discipline, discipline. Don't get in second and long. Don't get in third and long.
Demons were not set up and ready to go, but I think we're going to have a false start against Sam Houston, which will help the Demons out.
False start. Number 71, offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
That's right guard Tyler Edwards, the junior from Buna, Texas. How about this? Last year, Sam Houston had the exact same starting 5 offensive linemen for all 14 games. This year, it has been all kind of issues with trying to get the right people on the field at the right time. Right now, they've got a brand new left tackle who's listed as their starting left guard. So it's a mess. Brock, though, quick throw across the middle, tipped and incomplete, went off the hands of his intended receiver, Woody Branson. The tight end, Branson, was sitting down at about 5 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 15.
That's amazing when you think about it, Patrick, for Sam Houston to play 14 games with the same offensive lineman.
That's amazing.
I mean, when you consider injuries, and we've certainly seen over the years the injuries that Northwestern has suffered on the offensive line.
No doubt about it. And again this year, again, Demons played with just 5 offensive linemen last week. 2 receivers to either side. Now the Davion Davis will go out of the backfield in motion to slot left. Quick look. Brock's going to throw the deep corner pattern up the sideline. That one is caught. Flag is down. Touchdown is the call. On the far side, I believe that was Tyler Scott again.
Rashad Crony was the cover man.
Yeah, and it looks like it's going to be pass interference against the Demon defense. That's going to be another touchdown.
Pass interference, number 6, defense. The penalty is behind. Result of the play is a touchdown.
Well, I'm not sure it was a touchdown, even if you don't consider the pass interference. It looked like when he came down, he hit short of the goal line. I think they're going to have to review this.
And they are.
The ruling of a catch and a touchdown is under further review.
It looked like when he made the grab, he was at about the 1-yard line when he hit down and then sort of bounced into the end zone, if you will. Nevertheless, though, Tony, I mean, Sam Houston, as of right now, 18 plays, 180 yards, averaging exactly 10 yards a play. Meanwhile, the Demons have 10 plays for just 37 yards. Sam Houston is vastly outplaying the Demons right now. Let's look at the scoreboard from around the league. The upset is complete in Abilene. Abilene Christian knocks off Nichols 28-12. Abilene doing good work out there. Central Arkansas defeated Stephen F. Austin in Nacogdoches 27-17. Southeastern leads Houston Baptist 42-30. Still 8 minutes left to go in the third quarter of that one. And probably the biggest upset, well, I don't know if it's the biggest upset, but another upset brewing down in Beaumont as Lamar and Incarnate Word are tied at 21. Keep in mind, Incarnate Word undefeated in Southland Conference play coming into this week thanks to a brand new offense and their new head coach. He has come in and installed that Texas Tech Cliff Kingsbury version of the spread, and it has worked wonders.
UIW had
here's the rule.
After further review, the receiver caught the ball but was down short of the goal line at the 1 yard line. It will be Sam Houston's ball at the one, first and goal.
There you go. So Sam Houston take the touchdown off the board to see if the Demons can find a way to get a goal line stand here. Ty Brock has been absolutely incredible so far. 9 of 12, 110 yards. One touchdown and the one pick he threw to Shamar Bartholomew. Meanwhile, Shelton Epler, 3 for 6 for 40 yards. Two receivers right, one to the left. It's straight man everywhere. Everyone else is inside the box. Brock calls for the football, hands off up the middle. Nothing doing there. Big, big push of Demon bodies to make sure the tailback doesn't get in the end zone. And then, boy, Nick Ford got thrown down late by center Tristan Wendt. I think if Ford kept his feet, I think if Ford goes down, that might be a 15-yard penalty on the Bearcats. So Sam's going to go now three receivers to the left. He's going to stay with that power formation, tight end up to the right side. Second and goal from the two. Brock's going to throw to the middle, wide open, touchdown, Davion Davis. Just beat Ryan Reed on a quick inside move. And a little play action inside, and Davis was wide open for the touchdown. So Sam Houston goes up 13-0 on NSU. The Demon defense has not put up a lot of resistance to Sam's offense in the first two drives. Meanwhile, the Demon offense has struggled to get anything going against the Sam Houston defense. And that's really the difference in this Sam team that in years past, they've always had a great offense, but their defense has been the struggle. This year, they have the third best defense in terms of scoring and yards allowed in the Southland Conference, and that's not normally been the case under KC Keeler. Timeout on the field, 4:19 left to go first quarter after the extra point. Demons trail 14-0. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network.
Barbier! Before being named the head coach at his alma mater in June 2017, Barbier spent two seasons as Northwestern State's pitching coach. In 2016, Barbier's pitching staff ranked ninth nationally with a 3.01 ERA. As a player, Barbier finished his four-year career as the school's leader in the career hit by pitches and was in the top 10 in seven other offensive categories. Barbier led Northwestern State to its first Southland Conference Tournament Championship in May, breaking a 13-year NCAA regional drought. Under Barbier's direction, the Demons defeated San Diego State 9-0 on June 2nd to post the school's first NCAA postseason shutout in program history. After leading the Demons, picked to finish 11th in the Southland Conference to a record-setting turnaround, Barbier was named Coach of the Year by the Southland Conference, the Louisiana Sports Writers Association, and was chosen the American Baseball Coaches Association Central Region Coach of the Year. Give it up for tonight's Demon Great of the Game, head baseball coach Bobby Barbier.
Family Farm and Garden, located in Manny. Take a look at the drive summary. Sam Houston, 7 plays, 54 yards. It took a minute 55 off the clock. Ty Brock from 2 yards to Davion Davis. It's Davis's second touchdown grab of the first quarter, his sixth of the year. And Northwestern State finds itself down 14-0. And, Tony, I mentioned to Brad Laird during the pregame interview that, you know, you don't typically win or lose a game in the first quarter, But the momentum of last week when the Demons did not score on those three possessions at the 50 or better, it sure feels like there's momentum going the wrong way right now for this Demon team.
Well, I can tell you that defensive coordinator Mike Lucas is seeing what you saw, Patrick. He just told his defense, I can call every play in the playbook, but if you don't tackle and you don't make plays, it's not going to do any good. He said they're running right through us. And, Patrick, I'm drawing a blank. Ratliff's first name for us.
Kevin
Ratliff. He just told his teammates, we are playing soft. We're doing a lot of talking, but we're not backing it up. So he's trying to hold his teammates accountable.
Kevin Ratliff, who was injured a couple of weeks ago, didn't play last week and haven't seen him yet this week, I don't believe. Miles Ward's going to fumble the kickoff into the end zone. He's going to bring it out, try to get what he can out of it. He will get across the 15 to about the 16-yard line. So after the fumbled attempt on the kickoff, gets about 16, 17 yards out of it. 4:11 left to go in the first quarter. Northwestern State finds itself down 14-0. The Demons are facing the stalwart of the Southland Conference for the last decade. One of just three teams in the last 7 years to reach the FCS playoffs. The others are New Hampshire and North Dakota State. And I'm going to tell you in just a second what North Dakota State's record is since 2011. It blew my mind. To be an inside handoff, and there's just not much there. The running game has really been a struggle this year. The Demons coming in averaging 96 yards rushing a game. Last week had just 62 yards rushing against Nichols, and that's fine if you're, you know, if you're throwing for 350 and you're getting everything out of the passing game. But when you don't have the passing game working to complement the running game, not being able to run the ball hurts. So now 2nd and 9 for the Demons at their own 17. Two receivers right, one to the left. That's Jazz Ferguson in motion. Fake inside, little half roll for Epler. Throws it out. Great catch by Quan Shorts on a not very well thrown ball by Epler to the 21-yard line, a pickup of 4.
So in the last, what was North Dakota's record?
In the last 7 years, Sam Houston has the second best record in the FCS, 83-27. All right, Sam Houston, 83-27 in the last 7 years. North Dakota State is 102-8. In the last 7 years. That is unreal. 3rd down and 6 for the Demons. Epler drops. Rolls out to his right under pressure. He's going to throw it up the sideline. It's caught. Flag down. This could be illegal touching on Stafford Anderson. The question is, did Anderson go out of bounds or was he forced out of bounds? If he was forced out of bounds, it will be a legal play. If he went out of bounds on his own, it's illegal touching.
So if you're out of bounds, you can't
there
be the first.
There is no foul going out of bounds and coming back in. Result of the play is 1st down.
So the referee decided, or the official on that sideline, said that Stafford Anderson was pushed out of bounds and then came back in to reestablish himself. So that's a great job by Shelton Epler on the move and a great job by Stafford Anderson, the tailback, with his 7th reception of the year, coming back into the field of play and making the grab all the way up at the 43-yard line. 22 yards on the completion. 3 receivers left, triangle formation, 1 to the right. Inside fake, then up the right sideline. Great grab by Jalen Watson, and a flag is down at the 32-yard line. Watson makes the grab. If it stands, it's going to be defensive pass interference, and that'll be declined.
Pass interference, number 9, defense. 15-yard penalty, 1st down.
Jalen Thomas gets called for the pass interference, and one of the things that Brad Smiley, the offensive coordinator, talked about was, look, Sam Houston is a man.
The penalty is declined. The result of the play is a 1st down.
Sam Houston is a man defense. He said they are going to challenge our receivers at the line of scrimmage. We must make plays against man press coverage. That's what they're seeing all over the field. 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. Counter play to Stafford Anderson. Ball is fumbled, but Shelton Epler gets back on top of it for a loss of 3 at the Sam Houston 35-yard line. It was a counter run to Stafford Anderson, and the exchange went wrong. Luckily, Epler was able to jump back on top of it. 2nd and 13 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 35. 2:17 left to go first quarter. Sam leads 14-0. Demons, though, driving. 3 receivers, triangle formation left, 1 to the right, 1 safety deep. Quick throw to the outside, caught by Quan Shorts. He will go back to the middle, then back outside before he's taken down He gets the lost yardage back and about a half more. And that'll bring up third down and very long for the Demons.
Patrick, you were talking about Northwestern's receivers playing against man coverage. Receivers coach Alvin Slaughter was telling me before the ball game, if you're a receiver, you love that. You love playing against man coverage. It's mano a mano. It's may the best man win, and his receivers like that challenge.
Demons are 2 for 3 on third downs. They face third and 10 from the Sam 32, probably four down territory here. Sam showing blitz, three receivers right, one to the left. That's Ferguson. He's in press man coverage. Epler drops, looks right, throws to the deep middle. That one is incomplete, a little bit behind Quan Shorts on the deep post pattern. And that'll bring up fourth down and 10 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 32. And I imagine they're going for it here. Are the Demons down 14 to nothing. Lamar and Incarnate Word tied at 21. Incarnate Word lines up for the game-winning field goal attempt. Lamar blocks it and returns it for a touchdown to win. Lamar wins 27-21 over Incarnate Word. That is the first defeat in conference play for the Cardinals, the Incarnate Word Cardinals. Fourth and 10 for the Demons here at the Sam 32. Two receivers to either side. Again, Sam Houston, everybody at the line of scrimmage showing blitz. Epler in the shotgun. He drops. Three-man rush. Epler throws it to the deep out. That's caught. First down for the Demons. Jalen Watson at the 20-yard line. Epler was nailed as he got rid of the football, but a beautiful outcut from Jalen Watson and a first down for the Demons. That was huge.
Give a lot of credit to Shelton Epler. He knew he was going to get hit. He could feel the pressure. He waited until the very last minute to throw the football, and it paid off. But he took a heck of a hit.
He did. Got 11, though, when he needed 10. Actually, they gave him about 12. So first and 10 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 20. Got to pay this off. Two receivers left, one to the right. Jazz Ferguson in short motion. To be an inside handoff to Stafford Anderson, who lowers the shoulder and gets about two. Sledding Stafford. Tough.
Stafford Anderson celebrated a birthday earlier this week.
The sophomore from Baton Rouge. Figured to be the feature back today. It was going to be interesting to see how much Jared West could go dealing with that turf toe injury. Turf toe sounds like such a benign injury, but I've never had it. I've seen people who had it. It is insanely painful. Two receivers left, one to the right. Stretch play to the left side for Anderson, trying to turn the corner. Flag comes flying in on what could very likely be a holding penalty here. Jazz Ferguson was out there blocking on the edge, and I wonder if they hit him for a hold.
Holding, number one, offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay second down.
And there again, Tony, the Demons shooting themselves in the foot. Last week had just 5 penalties for 48 yards, which was about half of what they normally average. But it seemed like every penalty was at the worst possible time. That penalty also not at a great time, as the Demons were looking at second down and about 8 and had run the football. Now it's all the way back to second down and 18.
You were talking about turf toe with Jared West. I asked head athletic trainer Jason Drury, I said, in layman's terms, explain turf toe. He said it's basically if you jammed your finger, you've jammed your big toe, and he said Jared West is very tough because this is very painful.
It is indeed, and that will end the first quarter of action.
That is the end of the first quarter.
Demons finally getting a drive going here after Sam Houston scored twice. Demons trail 14-0 as we head to the second period. You are listening to the Demons Sports Network.
Head football coach at Northwestern State University. And I want to welcome the 2023-2024 students here to Turpin Stadium tonight that are attending Inside View Day here at Northwestern State University. We appreciate your support, and we look forward to seeing you here in the future. Forkum Demons.
head to the second quarter of action. Northwestern State finds itself down 14-0, but the Demons are driving when we get back to action. Tony just asked me, and I will pass this along on the air for those that may be interested, maybe got to the stadium and didn't follow along. Georgia found itself on the wrong end of defeat. 36-16 was the win for LSU over Georgia at home. Second down and 18 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 28-yard line. They need the 10 to get a first down. Play action inside, under pressure, deep middle. Jazz Ferguson's got it. Breaks two tackles, heads towards the right sideline. 10-5, touchdown, Demons! Jazz Ferguson gets it done! Shelton Epler is slow getting up after he absolutely got obliterated by Derek Roberson. Epler is clutching his left arm and sort of left side as he comes off the field. He got hammered by Roberson, but hung in and threw the deep end to Jazz Ferguson, who did the rest, and the Demons are on the board.
Patrick, the way this game was going, that was more than a touchdown. The way Jazz Ferguson broke tackles, made men miss. He electrified his teammates. He electrified the crowd.
Well, he actually had two guys on him when he made the grab. He broke both of those tackles and then went all the way across the field, picked up a block, by the way, on the near sideline, and scored from there. Take a break. 14:51 left to go in the first half. A huge touchdown for the Demons of 28 yards from Epler to Jazz Ferguson. Take a timeout. Come back with more after this on the Demons Sports Network.
Welcome to the field. Our guest coaches for the evening, Catherine Yandell, Exercise Physiology Faculty, Department of Health and Human Performance, and Dr. John Dunn, Assistant Professor of Fine Arts, Fine Arts Survey, Course Steward, School of Creative and Performing Arts. Thank you for all you do and for helping coach the Demons to victory tonight. Let's give our guest coaches a big Demon round of applause.
Sponsors of the Demon Huddle, and Jimmy Grange, Natchitoches, Ford, Lincoln. Drive summary, Northwestern State, 10 plays, 84 yards, took 4:20 off the clock. Shelton Epler on third down and forever finds Jazz Ferguson on a deep end pattern for 28 yards. It was second down and forever on a deep end to Jazz Ferguson, 28 yards as he went all the way across the field after breaking two tackles and scored. Jazz Ferguson, who had been frustrated the last couple of weeks. Last week, Jazz had just two catches for 54 yards already, three catches for 61 and a touchdown tonight. Kickoff is high and short to the right side numbers, trying to find a hole going all the way across the field. Now cutting it up before being taken down is Jalen Harris for the Bearcats.
Patrick, some good news. You mentioned quarterback Shelton Epler slow to get up and walking off the field. It looked like he was feeling the worst of that hit that he took. I can tell you that he is not being looked at by the medical staff. He was on the sidelines a second ago with the headsets on talking to the assistant coaches upstairs. So hopefully he was able to shake that off.
Chatting with his quarterback's coach, Anthony Selfo, upstairs. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Ty Brock has been nearly perfect tonight. Going to look quick left throw, and one hops it to Nathan Stewart, as that was not a tough throw, and he just one-hopped it to him. So Ty Brock now 11 for 15 for 141 yards, two touchdowns, one interception. Epler now 9 of 13 for 134 yards, one touchdown, one interception. Second and 10 for the Demons, for the Bearcats at their own 31. Two receivers right, one left. This will be outside zone, cutting it up. Nothing there. Ryan Reed came up to fill that hole in a hurry. And then Jalen Sangster and the freshman Nathalan Nanai all getting there to make the stop. Boy, they love Nathalan Nanai, the true freshman from Killeen, Texas, who played for one of the great Demon defensive linemen of the last decade or so, Roy Locks. Demons will bring four. Straight drop for Brock under pressure. He'll escape, step up, try to get the first down, won't have it. Demons will corral him about 3 yards shy of the first down, and it looks like the Demon defense will get off the field here, three and out. Great work by the Demon defensive crew.
Perhaps some of that momentum from Jazz Ferguson's touchdown has carried over to the defense.
Well, you knew that Mike Lucas would make adjustments. He is a guy who is he's one of the better X's and O's defensive coaches you'll ever see. Matter of fact, a little bit of a, not a homecoming because it's not at Sam Houston, but he was the defensive coordinator for Sam Houston for 17 years under venerable head coach Ron Randleman. This kick is high, high, high in the air. Bourgeois calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 15-yard line. So the Demons will go back on offense after the defense pitches a three and out. And we'll see if NSU, what they can do when we return. 13:23 left to go in the first half of play. Northwestern State down 14-7. Back on offense when we return on the Demon Sports Network.
To the Landing for providing BOGO burgers and beer special. Present your game ticket at the Landing after the game for buy one, get one free burgers and beer at the Landing.
Four, tres, two, uno. Listen up, y'all, cause this is it. The beat that I'm banging is delicious. Burgerlicious definition, make the boys go loco. They want my treasure so they get the clutches from my belter. You can see me, you can't squeeze me. I ain't easy, I ain't sleazy. I got reasons why I tease them. Boys just come and go like seasons from the riches. Bet my angel promiscuous. And if you were suspicious, all that fictitious, I will kiss.
By the way, we're going to go ahead and give away our Louisiana Fish Fry Big Play giveaway on that Jazz Ferguson 28-yard catch and run for touchdown. Louisiana Fish Fry, brought to you by Louisiana Fish Fry Products, featuring chicken fry, hush puppy mix, fish fry cocktail sauce, tartar sauce, just to name a few. Call 318-352-9696, 352-9696. Call that right now. Mark Fox will pick up the phone. He'll pick a winner. You don't have to give an answer to any trivia question or anything. Just call 352-9696 right now, and you can win a gift pack of Louisiana Fish Fry products for the Louisiana Fish Fry Big Play. Two receivers left, one to the right. Pistol formation, Demons down 14-7. Flag immediately. Huge run right up the middle by Jared West all the way to the 45-yard line, but I think it might be coming back. This is either going to be an illegal formation. Nope, it's offsides. It'll count. 30-yard run for Jared West.
Offside, number 49, defense. The penalty is declined. The result of the play is a first down.
Well, how about we give it away for that one, too? The Demons needing something in the running game. Congratulations to Henry Maggio. Henry Maggio. I'm assuming not Chris Maggio. I don't know that the NSU president is eligible for this prize, but congratulations, Henry Maggio. You have won a gift pack for Louisiana Fish Fry Big Play for the Jazz Ferguson thing. And then that, how about Jared West up the middle? West gets another carry for a gain of two. So the Demons, before that run of 29 yards, had minus 3 yards rushing in the first half. But a huge gap right up the middle for Jared West to go through for a gain of 29.
By the way, Patrick, we may be on the verge of getting wet. There's been a lot of rain in East Texas, a lot of severe weather in East Texas. It was hopeful that that rain would move to the north of us, but looking at the radar, it's on our doorstep.
Quick throw to the outside is caught by Bryson Bork, but no gain on the play as they rolled the pocket to the left. Bork went out into the flat, and the strong safety Adrian Contreras came up like a shot to take Bork down right at the line of scrimmage. That was basically the same play they ran to collect the first down on third and medium earlier in the game. So now another third down here, third and eight for the Demons. Demons are 2 for 4 on third down conversions. Third and eight from their own 47. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Straight drop for Epler. Steps and throws to the deep middle. Wide open is LeVar Gums, and he'll make the grab inside the 35, down to the 33-yard line. The true freshman from Houston with his seventh reception of the year.
You mentioned defensive coordinator Mike Lucas, very good at making in-game adjustments. Looks like offensive coordinator Brad Smiley is doing some different things.
Absolutely. LeVar Gums with the deep crossing pattern there. First and 10 at the 32 now. Epler's going to hard count and check to the sideline after that completion for 22 yards. That puts LeVar Gums over 100 yards receiving on the year in this his freshman season. Also has a pair of touchdowns on the season. Two receivers right, one to the left. Pistol formation, West behind Epler with 10 to snap it. Kalen Meggs across the formation in motion. Handoff over the right tackle side. West gets the corner, 30, 25, lowers the shoulder down to the 23-yard line. Actually going to give him the 24, so 2 yards shy of a first down, a gain of 8.
Jared West received an injection earlier this week just to help keep the inflammation down from that turf toe. It looks at field level like he is about a half a step slower than usual. That is certainly understandable with that painful turf toe, but he's showing a lot of toughness playing tonight.
Sam showing double A-gap blitz as the Demons dummy called, now changing their play call. Two receivers left, one to the right. That's Gums, the freshman. No safety over to the left side. Handoff up the middle to West. Cuts it back over right tackle. He's got the first down and down to the 20-yard line. We saw Jared West with his first 100-yard game a couple of weeks ago against Southeastern Louisiana. Had a whale of a ball game in that one. Northwestern State. Now Casey Keeler is going to take a timeout as his defense is reeling. He is screaming at his defense to come over.
Timeout. Sam Houston, they're first. It will be 30 seconds.
So that'll allow us to keep it here. By the way, I want to send some congratulations, some shout-outs, Tony. A lot of other Demon sports that are doing good things right now. The volleyball team has rallied up nicely, won a couple of games in a row. They found themselves with a nice win today against Lamar this morning. They took care of the Cardinals in three straight sets, just like they did against McNeese on Thursday night. The tennis team has also had, again, they're just kind of in their fall season right now. A couple of their players advanced into the semifinals of the Ole Miss tournament at the Southern Regional of the Intercollegiate Tennis Association. So terrific work there. And by the way, would be remiss if we didn't mention the cross country team, who had a great showing in earlier action at the Mississippi College Invitational. Both teams finished in the top third with big, big fields, 22 teams running in that one. And so good work all the way around by NSU Athletics here in the fall. So first and 10 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 20-yard line. Two receivers left, one to the right. Back to the left of Epler with Meggs, the up back to the left side as well. Now West will move to the right side of Epler, still 12 to snap it. Seven in the box for Sam Houston. Demons run it anyway with Jared West, and he goes nowhere. Might have lost a half a yard. This is the number one pressure-oriented defense in the Southland Conference. 9 tackles for loss a game for Sam Houston. That leads the Southland Conference and is third most in the nation. They had 45 tackles for loss coming in. Demons quickly back to the line. Second and 10 at the 20. Pistol formation. Now another dummy call. Then they'll check the sideline. Three different guys, two assistant coaches, and now fourth-string quarterback Aaron Howell back there giving signs. Play action inside for Epler. Good pockets, shifts to his left and throws it over the head of Quan Shorts, incomplete. That'll bring up third and 10 from the 20. 9:49 left to go in the first half. The Demons trail 14-7, but scored on their last possession, held Sam Houston to three and out, and now driving on 3rd and 10. The Demons now 3 for 5 on 3rd downs. If they can keep that type of percentage up, they'll be very successful.
And if this becomes a 14-14 ball game and the Demon defense has tightened, it looks like, the game takes on a whole different look.
Absolutely. Two receivers left, two to the right. One safety in the middle of the field right now for Sam Houston. 3rd and 10. They're going to fake inside on the sweep. Stepping up is Epler. Throws to the deep middle. That one is tipped up and caught. What a grab. Quan Shorts comes up with the tip ball reception at the 5-yard line. 15 yards and 1st and goal.
It happened right in front of me. The Sam Houston defensive backs are saying that the ball touched the ground. It did not. That was outstanding concentration by Quan Shorts.
Sam Houston is being allowed to substitute because the Demons substituted. So Sam is matching it. 1st and goal from the 5. This is where the Demons have struggled the last couple of weeks. Inside handoff, Jared West. He'll get a couple. They'll give him the 4 for a gain of 1 yard. That'll bring up 2nd and goal. And Demons, this ought to tell you all you need to know. The Demons last week had 10 plays inside the 10-yard line. The last 2 weeks, 10 plays inside the 10-yard line and scored nothing. Two receivers left, one to the right. Epler gives to West up the middle. Flag comes flying in from the referee, and that usually means a blocking penalty of some kind. And we've got a hold against the Demon offense.
Holding, number 57. Offense, 10-yard penalty. Replay 2nd down.
That's right guard Timmis Bonner. And once again, Tony, the Demons' 4th penalty of the ball game, but comes at an absolutely crucial time when the Demons are looking at 3rd and goal inside the 3.
And the longer you get in the red zone and don't score like they've had trouble doing the last 2 ball games, it becomes mental as well.
It's like missed free throws. You know, and Brad Laird 2 weeks ago talked about how he was going to stop talking about penalties. And last week his team had 5 penalties, half of what they normally have. This week they've already got 5. Epler, play action outside. He's going to step up and run. Lot of room, 10-5, trying to lower the shoulder. Ball comes free, and there's a pileup at the 2-yard line, and Epler comes up slowly. And Sam Houston has the football.
Result of the play is a fumble recovered by the defense. 1st down, Sam Houston.
Well, here's the thing, Tony. You admire the gusto and the guts from Shelton Epler, but at the same time, that's 2nd and goal. Get down at the 2 or 3 yard line and then try to get it on 3rd and goal. You don't necessarily have to be the hero there. He picked up all of the yardage back that was lost on the penalty.
That is a tough way for that drive to end.
Absolutely. Fumble inside the 5. 2nd time we've seen that, by the way, in the last 3 weeks. Demons fumbled inside the 5 at Southeastern. They're going to confirm that this is indeed a fumble. And we are set to go.
Shelton Epler has taken some hits tonight.
Absolutely. Well, he put that one on himself. 1st and 10 from the 2-yard line. Brock looking to the sideline now. 8:44 left to go in the half. The Demons are down 14-7 after fumbling it at the 2-yard line. 3 receivers left. A lot of room out there. Demons showing corner blitz. They bring it, run up the middle. Not much there. Nothing, as a matter of fact. Terrific work by, I believe that was Jalen Sangster, who made the stop right in the middle of the field. Maybe a 0.5-yard gain on that one. It'll bring up 2nd and 9. Or 9.5, whatever you want to call it. 3 receivers again left. Tight end up to the right side. Brock claps twice. This will be keeping it, throwing it to the middle. Incomplete, almost intercepted. He threw it high looking for Davion Davis on the slant pattern. It popped out of his hands, and Ryan Reed was almost able to dive and make the grab. Now 3rd down and basically 10. Gotta keep Sam Houston right here. Cannot let them have a 1st down and get out of this hole. 3rd and 10 from their own 2-yard line. After the Demons fumbled, again, give Epler all the credit in the world for toughness and daring do, but you've got to be careful in that scenario. 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. Back goes out of the backfield in motion. Quarterback draw for Brock. Brock is hit and dropped at the 2-yard line. Isaiah Longino, no, Quindarius Whitley coming up to make the stop on that one. Whitley was the spy on Brock. Brock got a yard, and the Demon defense, for the second drive in a row, pitches a three and out, and now NSU should have fantastic field position on the exchange.
Brock stumbled for a half a second as he started to run, and that half a second allowed Quindarius Whitley to get to him. And, you know, nothing erases that turnover just at the, 2-yard line or so,
yeah.
But that defensive stop makes it a little more bearable.
And how about the Demons have not given up a first down, 2-3 and outs on the last two drives. Punt is away. It is a good one. Bourgeois makes the grab at the 50-yard line, coming to his right, now tries to split defenders and will roll over a tackler before going down inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. 7:22 left to go in the first half of play. The Demons get the ball back in tremendous field position. Trailing 14-7, you're listening to the Demon Sports Network.
All right, fans, it's time to get up and get loud for your maniac from Kane's Chicken Fingers. Show us how you can be a maniac for a Caniac.
The guy you have coming up at halftime, maybe you should send him over to Shelton Epler and get a quick sliding lesson with him. The coach of the year in the Southland Conference, Tony, that's your halftime guest.
It is. Bobby Barbier is tonight's Exchange Bank Demon Great of the Game. Of course, an outstanding student athlete. Not all those many years ago here at Northwestern, and he is the toast of the town right now after managing the Demon baseball team to the Southland Conference tournament title last year and a very impressive run in the NCAAs.
Amazingly enough, for all the success NSU Demon baseball has had, they had never won the Southland tournament before until last year with Bobby Barbier and a heck of a first baseman in his own right. Three receivers, triangle formation left, one to the right, first and 10 from the Sam Houston 44. Epler in the gun, calls for the football, inside fake. Good pocket, steps up, throws to the deep middle, wide open, touchdown, Quan Shorts! And the Demons are an extra point away from tying it after a 44-yard pitch and catch. No one is more excited right now than Brad Smiley, the Demon offensive coordinator. Dialed up a beautiful post pattern. Quan Shorts broke wide open. It was a perfect pocket that Epler was able to step into and throw. And Epler, who last week threw for just 218 yards against Nichols, is 3 yards shy of that now with 7 minutes left to go in the first half of play. Shelton Epler now 13 of 18, 215 yards. Two touchdowns and one interception. Let's take a look at the drive summary on that one. One play, 44 yards, 6 seconds. Epler to Quan Shorts for the touchdown. That is the second receiving touchdown of the year for Quan Shorts, the transfer from Texas Tech. And that is the 12th passing touchdown of the year for Shelton Epler.
Well, you mentioned how excited Brad Smiley was when his offense came off the field. Remember, a few minutes ago, I talked about how he really tore into his offense when they were struggling. So, you know, when you chew them out when they don't play well, but when they make a great play, you got to give them praise.
No doubt about it. And, by the way, huge credit to the offensive line, Tony. Created the perfect pocket around Epler allowed him to step up and make an easy throw right down the middle to a wide open Quan Shorts. A huge bust by the secondary for Sam Houston. And the Demons have tied this up at 14 apiece after going down 14-0 in the first quarter. Short kickoff fielded at the 13-yard line, coming around to the right side. Ball is out. Demons have it. Northwestern State has the football, and I believe, Tony, was it the true freshman Kobe McGee who made the strip?
Result of the play is a fumble recovered by the kicking team. First down, Northwestern.
The true freshman Kobe McGee from Airline High School, 5'11", 184. We've been waiting to see him make a big play in special teams. We thought it might be in the return game, but in this one, it was creating a fumble at the 24-yard line.
Kobe McGee is receiving all kinds of headbutts and chest pumps here on the sideline.
Does he get the turnover trident? That's what I want to know. Is that I mean, that's a turnover, so
they're giving it to him.
The man the trident, for goodness sakes.
There he goes.
He's parading it down the sideline as we speak. Having a lot of fun. Good for the true freshman from Airline High School. First and 10 for the Demons at the Sam 24. Inside handoff. Jared West breaks two tackles and then will get forward progress to the 20-yard line. A gain of four for Jared West. And suddenly this Demon offense, which had just negative 3 yards rushing in the first quarter, has 59 yards rushing here in the second quarter. They've also thrown for 109 in the second quarter as well. Two receivers left, one to the right. Jazz Ferguson back in. Epler's just going to throw the fade to Ferguson up the left side. Touchdown, Demons! That man does it again, Jazz Ferguson. A matchup nightmare anywhere he is on the field. He gets his second touchdown grab of the ball game. 20 yards from Shelton Epler, who throws his third touchdown of the first half, and the Demons take their first lead of the game, 20-14.
As rain begins to fall here at Turpin Stadium.
Let's call the rest of the game. End it right here. 21-14 sounds like a good final score to me. The extra point is up, and it is good from Austin Fendrick. 6:37 left to go in the first half of play, and what was a 14-0 deficit is now a 21-14 lead for Northwestern State. We'll take a break, come back with more after this. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network. After a one-play, 44-yard drive, the Demons recover the fumbled kickoff and then go two plays, 24 yards. Jazz Ferguson with his second touchdown grab of the ballgame. That gives him now six touchdowns on the year, and the Demons take a 21-14 lead. Ball kicked off almost to the sideline, but a bit of a crease there across the 30, across the 35 goes the return man, Jalen Harris. But boy, Tony, this game has turned on a dime. And with 6.5 left to go in the first half, Demons lead 21-14.
Well, a couple of things, Patrick. While that kickoff was taking place that Sam Houston fumbled, I was asking Quan Shorts at the other end of the field, I said, how did you get so wide open? He said, I don't know, but we ran that exact play in practice 10 times, and it worked all 10 times, and that time it worked just like it did in practice.
Well, I talked to Brad Smiley, and he said, look, I've got a couple of plays in the playbook that I think will work multiple times in this game if I get the right look. Straight drop for Brock. Blitz comes. Well picked up. The out pass is dropped. Oh, they're going to say he caught it. Oh, no, there is no doubt that ball came out as he hit the ground. That needs to be reviewed. There is. I'm watching it from here, and as he hit the ground, the ball came out of his possession and then went back into his possession. That was no doubt an incomplete pass, but Sam Houston already to the line. No review. Brock, quick throw on the out pattern, caught again by Nathan Stewart, who's thrown to the ground by Deron Littleton. Well, if I was Brad Laird, I might have challenged that one, Tony, because I could see it from here. When he hit the ground, the ball popped out of Nathan Stewart's hands, and then he re-caught it while he was out of bounds.
The assistant coaches were screaming about it as well.
Yeah. No replay buzz down from the booth, which should be automatic. And no challenge. Inside handoff, good running room, and then tripped up on second down and four at the Demon 40-yard line. Now third and two for Sam Houston at the Demon 40-yard line. The Bearcats are 1-for-3 on third downs, coming in 38% third downs on the season, while the Demons give up 52%, dead last in the nation, in the Southland. Handoff over right tackle, cutting it up. No, didn't get it. A yard and a half shy of the first down at the 39-yard line. Fourth and one, Casey Keeler is standing at the 39-yard line. I don't think he's punting this. 5:09 left to go in the first half. The Demons now lead 21-14. Sam's ready to go. They're on the sideline. They're at the line of scrimmage. Snap, handoff up the middle, and he's got it. Oh, maybe not. Now he surges late, and he gets the first down over right tackle. Boy, it was initially about a half yard shy and then a late surge.
Result of the play is a first down.
Kyron Jackson around the right tackle side. He was able to get the half yard he needed for the first down. So it's first and 10 for Sam at the Demon 38. By the way, the Demons are nearing 300 yards of offense in the first half. 291 right now. They had just 103 in the first half. They've got 188 in the second quarter. Demons showing blitz. Inside handoff and dropped right in the backfield. Blake Stevenson, the middle linebacker, picks up the tackle for loss, a loss of a yard to the 39.
A lot of football left to be played, but if Northwestern were to pull off the upset tonight, this is the kind of game that if you win, it can turn your whole program around.
It can certainly get you going in the right direction. Two receivers left, one to the right. Tight end and a back split to either side of Brock. He drops. Pressure comes. Steps up. He's hit and dropped in the backfield. Jalen Sangster got him for a loss of two. Brock tried to step up and run, and Sangster, the senior from Louisville, Mississippi, was right there to take him down, give him now 2.5 sacks on the year, and that'll bring up third down and 13 for the Bearcats at the Demon 41. Three receivers left, one to the right. Brock in the shotgun, claps twice, drops, four-man rush. He's going to throw to the deep sideline. That one is overthrown, looking for Tyler Scott, incomplete. And it's 4th and 13 from the 41. We'll see what Casey Keeler elects to do. Keeler tied for the 15th most wins of any head coach in FCS history with 223 total wins in his 25th year as a head coach.
Very successful at Delaware,
yeah.
Correct?
Rowan College, he went to 5 Division III championship games, didn't win any. At Delaware, he went to 3 FCS championship games, won one. And at Sam, he's gone to 3 semifinals in the FCS playoffs. This is going to be a pooch punt. It is straight up in the air. Bourgeois bobbles the drop. It's dropped at the 15-yard line, and Sam Houston recovers. Hayden Bourgeois just dropped the punt at the 15-yard line, and Sam Houston comes away with it. It'll be 1st and 10.
The ball was touched by a member of the receiving team and recovered by the kicking team. First down, Sam Houston.
So Sam, after the muffed punt, will get the ball 1st and 10 at the Demon 16-yard line with 3:14 left to go in the first half, and NSU nursing a 21-14 lead. So the Demons got a turnover in special teams on a kickoff 2 kickoffs ago, and now give one back on the muffed punt by Hayden Bourgeois. That is the Demons' star safety. Quick play action, throw to the middle is caught. Davis scores. Boy, he makes some incredible hands catches. But there is a flag down in the middle of the field. Might we have a hold call against the Sam Houston offensive line? It was the umpire who threw it.
An eligible receiver downfield, number 52, offense. 5-yard penalty. Replay first down.
That's Colby Thomas, the sophomore from Manville, Texas, the left guard, who right now I believe is playing left tackle. He is called for an ineligible man downfield. Keep in mind, in college, they give you 3 yards to go downfield as an offensive lineman, and they rarely call that. So if you get called for that as an offensive lineman, chances are you were a long way downfield. Brock drops, corner blitz comes. He's in trouble, hit as he throws, and that one sails out of the back of the end zone, incomplete. Demons brought the corner, Rashawn Crony, and he got there along with, trying to wait to see the number, that was the other buck end, Jamard Valson, the true freshman from Port Arthur Memorial High School, who got in there as well. Second and 15, back at the 21-yard line. Two receivers to either side. Brock calls for the football. Demons blitz again, picked up well. Plenty of time. Brock to the back of the end zone again and overthrows everyone. Longino was covering the slot receiver, Tyler Scott. Longino did not have bad coverage either for a linebacker. He was flying back there with Scott, but that ball was well out of the back of the end zone. And Tony, just looking at the flags, it seems like there's a good bit of wind down around the field.
When the game started, the wind was blowing out of the south at 12 miles an hour. It doesn't feel as windy down here at field level, but it is raining, but not very hard.
Third and 15 for Sam at the Demon 21. Brock drops, four-man rush, late blitz. He's going to go to the end zone right side, and that's again out of the back of the end zone, incomplete.
There's a flag down, Patrick.
Back around where the quarterback is. Is this roughing the passer?
Personal foul. Roughing number 51.
Yep.
Since the goal line.
The freshman, Nathalan Nanai, gets called for the roughing the passer penalty. So on two straight third downs, the Demons get off the field. They muff the punt on fourth down, and then here on third down, on the incomplete pass, they give up a roughing the passer penalty. 2:54 left to go in the first half. Demons lead 21-14.
Brad Laird was asking for and received a brief explanation from our headlinesman.
Now that is a tough, tough penalty as Brock let that one go. He has not been sharp here of late. Started the ball game 11 of 14. He's hit just 2 of his last 7. 3 receivers left, straight drop, quick throw to the outside, incomplete over the head of everyone. Nathan Stewart, Kyron Jackson, who I believe was the intended receiver on the outside. Excuse me, that was Stewart that was on the outside. Two of the better receivers in the Southland Conference on Sam Houston's side. The newcomer, Jazz Ferguson, who's made quite a statement tonight. 4 catches, 81 yards, and 2 TDs for him. Second and 10 from the 11. Brock, play action inside, looks to the middle, caught, touchdown, Davion Davis. Well, he did it earlier from a little bit further out, and it was called back for an eligible lineman downfield. Well, he goes that time from 11 yards, and we're an extra point away from being tied up at 21 with 2:46 left to go. Trey Honstein, the senior kicker from Georgetown, Texas, who tops in the Southland. 9 of 11 field goals coming in, and perfect 18 for 18 on extra points. That one is up and good. 2:46 left to go in the first quarter of action in Northwestern State. And Sam Houston now tied at 21. That drive, 4 plays, 16 yards. It took 28 seconds off the clock. Felt like it took an eternity after the muffed punt by the Demons. And NSU gives up the touchdown on 11-yard pass to Davion Davis. That is his third receiving touchdown of this first half. He's now got 5 catches for 66 yards and 3 scores. Jazz Ferguson has 4 for 81 and 2 scores. Good news is, Tony, the Demon offense seems to have found itself the last couple of possessions, and with 2:46 on the clock and all 3 timeouts, plenty of time to head down the field and maybe score another one.
Yeah, and that would certainly take away some of the bad taste from the turnover that led to the touchdown. When you're playing a team as talented as Sam Houston, and with their pedigree, 7 straight playoff appearances, you cannot give them extra possessions.
Certainly is not a good recipe, Tony, that's for sure. Coming up at halftime, we'll have your Tony Sachery's trivia question right before the interview, or right after the interview with Brad Laird, as this kickoff will bounce into the end zone and go actually hit the back pylon for a touchback, and the Demons will start at the 25-yard line offensively. Yeah, right after Demon head coach Brad Laird chats with Tony Taglivore, we'll have the Tony Sachery's trivia question. Keep in mind, this is the second consecutive ranked team that the Demons face. They'll likely face yet another ranked team next week at Central Arkansas. The last time the Demons beat a ranked opponent, it was Sam Houston back in 2014, when the Demons were able to take down the Bearcats in that one, 31-27. 21 all here, first and 10 for the Demons at their own 25. Pistol formation. Epler, handoff right up the middle. Little left tackle move to Jared West, and he gets about a yard, maybe 2. Well, now it's kind of an interesting scenario for the Demons, because you're tied. You know you get the ball to start the second half, so you're almost in between wanting to go fast and also take your time a little bit. Make sure you don't give Sam too much time should you give him the ball back. It's one of those where if you get the first down, then you start cranking the offense up. Play clock down under 15. Pistol formation, play action, Epler under pressure, and down he goes. Roberson body slams him. How is that not a flag? Roberson turned him around and absolutely slammed Shelton Epler to the turf. In the NFL, that'll get you kicked out of the league.
And fined.
Timeout.
And Sam Houston's going to take the timeout.
They're first.
Oh, wait a second.
It'll be 30 seconds.
Northwestern called the timeout. To be honest with you, I'm a little surprised
by
that. Yeah.
The timeout with Sam Houston is their second.
That makes a little bit more sense for Sam Houston to call the timeout after the Roberson sack.
Please reset the game clock to 2:08. 2:08.
So they'll put 2 seconds back on the clock. That is the second sack of the ball game for Sam Houston. And they come in averaging 3.5 sacks a game, which is second best in the Southland and top 10 in the nation. And we mentioned those 2 defensive ends. Derek Roberson, who is second in the conference with 5 sacks coming in, he got that one. And Eric Fowler, the other defensive end, who has 2.5 sacks on the year. Those are the guys you've got to watch out for. Both Texas transfers. Fowler came in last year from Texas, while Roberson came in now 2 years ago. So 3rd and a mile for the Demons, 3rd and 19 for NSU at their own 16-yard line. 2 receivers right, 2 to the left. Epler in the shotgun, drops. 4-man rush, pocket breaks down. He steps up in the pocket, throws to the deep middle. That one's incomplete, almost intercepted, and a flag, which might be holding against the Demon offensive line, and it'll be declined by Sam Houston, and they'll...
Holding, number 61, offense. The penalty is declined. 4th down.
That's left guard Frank Boudreaux, who is called for the holding penalty. The pass was intended for Markeesian Chapman. We haven't really called his name very much. He has not really been involved in the offense so far. Saw the deep ball to Quan Shorts. Shorts and Ferguson, the 2 transfers, 8 catches, 147 yards, and 3 touchdowns between them. And now Parker Pastorello comes in to punt. Just his 2nd punt of the ball game. He hit his first one 48 yards. He could use that and a little bit more in this one. He stands at his own 3-yard line to receive the snap. A little bit low. He's going to rugby-style kick this one. It goes about doesn't go more than a foot off the ground, but it gets a tremendous roll. Rolls all the way out and is down at the 43-yard line. So a 41-yard punt for Parker Pastorello, but... With a minute 50 left and 1 timeout, plenty of time for Sam Houston. They only need 57 yards for a touchdown. Demons went down 14 to nothing, scored 21 in a row. Then Sam has come back and scored, and now with a tie ball game, they will try to answer with more points. Demons will get the ball to start the second half. Two receivers to either side, shotgun for Brock. He drops, four-man rush. Pocket starts to break down. He throws it. One hops to his intended receiver across the middle as Zach Krolchik hit Ty Brock right as he released the football. He was looking for Tyler Scott, the slot receiver, and it bounced to him. Second and 10 with a minute 46 remaining. Two receivers again to either side. Shotgun for Brock. Calls for the football. Looking right. Throws the deep out. That one's almost intercepted. And Deron Littleton knocks it away. And we do have a flag in the secondary on the near side. It's going to be another ineligible receiver downfield against
ineligible
Sam Houston.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Number 71, offense. Five-yard penalty. Replay second down.
And Mike Lucas is asking Brad Laird to decline that penalty.
Well, you mentioned a minute ago, after the first offensive lineman was ineligible downfield, how rare it is for that to be called. And now we've had it called twice in the span of a few minutes.
That was Tyler Edwards who was called for
being
downfield. Northwestern
was elected to decline the penalty. It will be third down.
All right, so they're going to move the ball back to the original line of scrimmage. It would have been second and 15 from the 37. But Mike Lucas asked Brad Laird to decline the penalty. One of the things Brad Laird talked about was having two different coordinators who both have been head coaches. And he talked about how great it is to have them as a sounding board. And Mike Lucas that time put on his head coach hat, asked Brad Laird to decline it. He did. Brock drops. Good pocket. Throws deep down the right sideline. Jump ball knocked away by Deron Littleton. Terrific coverage on Nathan Stewart along the right sideline. And Sam Houston will be forced to punt it away.
And that's not just any receiver. That's one of the best in the country.
Yeah, Nathan Stewart and Davion Davis. Stewart last year led the FCS in receiving, while Davion Davis was the Southland Conference Offensive Player of the Year.
But there's no doubt Sam Houston misses Jeremiah Briscoe, who was the outstanding quarterback for, seems like, about the last 10 years.
Well, he was the back-to-back Peyton Award winner the last 2 years. So the Demons will force a punt. Hopefully Hayden Bourgeois will hold on to this one with a minute 34 remaining. Demons muff the last one. This one high, high. Boy, high punts as that one will go inside the five and is down around the five-yard line. They're going to put it at the five. That was Cameron Hearn on the punt, the junior from Gunter, Texas, who coming in had an average of just under 35. The normal punter for Sam Houston, Matt McRobert, the freshman from Australia, had been having a pretty good season, and then Tony was celebrating a tremendous punt and pulled a grammatica and blew out his knee while he was celebrating a punt. So now you have Cameron Hearn, who was the punter last year for Sam Houston, the junior from Gunter, Texas, and he's done a nice job so far. So now the Demons with first and 10 at their own five.
Patrick, Brad Laird is in the ear of the side judge, and now the head linesman comes over. And I think he was saying that I have three timeouts, not two. And he had the side judge pull out the little chart where they keep track of those things.
Well, remember, they set a timeout earlier on the third down sack, or the second down sack. They said it was a timeout Northwestern State, but then they changed their mind and said it was actually Sam Houston's timeout. So I believe you're correct, Tony. I believe the Demons do have three timeouts. They have first and 10 at their own five right now. Three receivers left, two to the right. Empty formation for Epler. Quick drop, under pressure, safety. Derek Roberson got him again, just went right up the middle, and Epler did not get rid of the football. He was just standing there, and Roberson,
result of the play is a safety.
Roberson hit him right at the legs and took him down. Well, that's just very poor awareness from the quarterback, Shelton Epler, who has been very good here the last couple of possessions. But on that one, Roberson moved inside, and Epler just waited and went right down, didn't throw it away, didn't do anything with it, just toppled over as he was hit in the legs. Again, in the NFL, that would have been a penalty for roughing the passer.
Well, after Northwestern had rallied from being down 14-0 in the first quarter to tie the ball game, Sam Houston has scored a touchdown and a safety to get the momentum back.
So Derek Roberson picks up another sack in this ball game. I'm going to look at his numbers real quick. That is now 3 sacks in this game, all 3 sacks in this game from Derek Roberson. That gives him now 8 sacks on the year, and because McNeese is idle, Derek Roberson is now the sack leader in the Southland Conference, overtaking B.J. Blunt of McNeese, the linebacker. And McNeese is idle this weekend. They have their bye, so that gives 3 sacks now to Roberson. He's got 8, and he now leads the Southland Conference in sacks. And it's 23-21 Sam Houston, and the Demons have to kick off here. The free kick from back at the 20-yard line. And it's always interesting to see what teams elect to do, whether they elect to kick off or punt. You can do either. Demons elect to kick off. It's fielded at the 25-yard line. Coming to the left side and into a big crowd short of the 40-yard line is the return man, Jalen Thomas. So with a minute 16 left and I believe just 1 timeout for Sam Houston, they have some opportunities here after the Demons took a safety on a very that was a bizarre play, too, because Epler took a short drop. It looked like he was looking for a quick throw, just held on to it, and Roberson came right through the middle and took him down by the legs.
It almost looked like Shelton didn't realize he was in the end zone.
I don't know. It was very bizarre looking. 2 receivers to either side. Shotgun for Ty Brock. Demon defense needs another stop. 4-man rush. Brock under pressure spins away from it to his left. Going to try to take off and run, and he'll go out of bounds right about the line of scrimmage. Actually, he'll lose a yard and a half, actually, on the scramble. Boy, Obi Ioma got into the backfield right off the snap of the football. He beat Colby Thomas, the left tackle, like a turnstile. And Brock, though, was able to spin away from Ioma and got out to the left side, lost a yard on the run. 2nd and 11, minute 9 left. Demons trail 23-21. Brock drops under pressure again, swings it out to his tailback, Kyron Jackson, who is taken down, Shamar Bartholomew and Blake Stevenson. And Sam Houston, I believe, will use their last timeout. It'll bring up 3rd down and about 7 for the Bearcats.
By the way, the rain.
Sam Houston, their last of the half.
There you go.
The rain has stopped, but Patrick, you are correct from what you observed a few minutes ago. The wind has picked up.
Minute 2 left to go. Coming up at halftime, Tony will chat with Brad Laird coming off the field, who I imagine will be both pleased and a bit miffed at what's gone on in this first half. But he will get the ball back to start the second half. So if you keep it at 23-21, you got to feel reasonably good about yourself going into halftime after you got down 14-0 to start this game. But the safety there was just baffling as the Demons, Shelton Epler, took the sack in the end zone on what looked like it was supposed to be a quick throw. He didn't even try to get the ball out of bounds or throw it away.
So after back-to-back home games, the Demons hit the road next week.
Yeah, on the road, heading north to Conway, Arkansas, to take on a Central Arkansas team that's on its 3rd quarterback, but still performing well. They got a nice win over Stephen F. Austin, 27-17 in earlier action. By the way, Southeastern and Houston Baptist, with 30 seconds left, I'm going to tell you that score after this play. 3rd down and 7 for Sam at their own 42. 2 receivers to either side. Demons jump, and then the right tackle moves. Let's see if Obi Ioma got into the neutral zone to cause the tackle to move, or if he just moved and stayed in his own side of the field, it's a false start. If he jumped into the neutral zone, it's an offsides.
Offside, number 11, defense, moving and causing a reaction by the offensive line. 5-yard penalty, 3rd down.
So instead of 3rd and 7, it'll be 3rd and 2. It appears the game has just gone final in Hammond. Southeastern Louisiana defeats Houston Baptist 62-52.
If you had the over.
The over was 113, Tony. Handoff right up the middle to Jackson. He'll get just enough for the first down and plus a couple of extra yards. Across midfield and into Demon territory. Clock stops momentarily with 57 seconds remaining. Now the clock starts winding again. 55 as Sam Houston goes to line up. First and 10 at the Demon 49. One receiver right, three to the left. Demons notice that a little bit late and roll a safety over. They're going to throw deep down the right sideline and incomplete. Good coverage by Rashawn Crony on the far sideline, intended for Tyler Scott. And it'll bring up second and 10 with 43 seconds left to go. And now an injured offensive lineman for the Bearcats. And much like the Demons, the Bearcats just don't have many offensive linemen left. The only player on their offensive line that has started every game this year is the all-conference center, Tristan Wendt. No one else has started every game this year, and they're missing their all-conference left tackle, their All-American, Mitchell Watanabe. He has not played in the last several games, so much like the Demons, who last week played just five offensive linemen, it has been a struggle for the Bearcats on the offensive line as well. Ty Brock, by the way, now is, after starting 11 for 14, has hit just four of his last 14 passes for 36 yards. Tony, I would say Mike Lucas has adjusted well.
He's one of the best when it comes to making in-game adjustments. The Sam Houston offense was just blowing through Northwestern's defense in that first quarter, but it's been a different story since.
Just 228 yards of offense on 45 plays here in the first half. After having 20 plays for 180 yards, their next 25 plays have netted them just 48 yards. Three receivers to the right, one to the left on second and 10 from the Demon 49. Brock in the shotgun, drops, four-man rush, good pocket. Now he's going to turn around and try to escape out to the right side. Here comes Isaiah Longino, throws late, and it's intercepted by Hayden Bourgeois. Touch to the middle at the 40, 35, 30. Here he goes, Hayden Bourgeois, touchdown, Demons! His fifth interception of the year, and it's a house call.
Jared Myatt, the strength and conditioning coach, is having to hold back the Demons on the sidelines. They were so excited, every player on the sideline wanted to run out onto the field and celebrate.
That was a tipped pass, and how about that? Demon defensive line coach Liddell Love comes out to give the turnover trident to Hayden Bourgeois. Tony, I think he made up for the muffed punt.
Wow. He sure did.
That was about 50 yards. Officially, it goes down 55 yards on the INT return for touchdown. And the Northwestern State Demons have retaken the lead 28-23 with 27 seconds left. Hayden Bourgeois, depending on what everyone else does nationally, we're not sure. Hayden Bourgeois, as of right now, as far as we know, tied for the lead in the nation in interceptions as he picked up his fifth.
The coaches like to say he has a knack for the football. Sometimes you come across those players that just seem to find the football.
Well, he certainly has done that. Hayden Bourgeois, the sophomore from Crowley, who was the defensive player of the year in the state of Louisiana at the 3A level at Notre Dame High School. And he has, they moved him from the free safety to the star safety position. And Mike Lucas's defense, the star safety, is that hybrid safety linebacker. And he, as Mike Lucas said, that's the position that needs to make plays. That's the guy that needs to be around the football. He said, and Hayden Bourgeois is that guy for our defense. He is always around the ball. He always makes plays. And he just picked up his fifth interception of the year and returned it 55 yards for the touchdown. And now the Demons take a 28-23 lead, 27 seconds before halftime.
You know, I've noticed all year long, whenever a player makes a big, big play like that, not just the players on his side of the ball come over to congratulate him, but the whole team does.
Demons are going to squib kick this one. It's bounced back to the return man. He's going to go all the way around the right side before he's corralled across the 25-yard line. And taken down there. That was, again, Jalen Harris on the return. So now let's see what Casey Keeler elects to do. He's got no timeouts, 20 seconds left to go on the clock. The Demons have a pick six. That's the second interception of the ball game for Ty Brock, who also has thrown three touchdowns. And it looks like Keeler's just going to take it into the locker room here as the Bearcats are lined up in the kneel-down victory formation, although you can't really call it a victory formation when it's halftime and you're down by five. So Sam Houston will kneel on it, and the Demons will take a 28-23 lead into halftime, doing it with defense. Sam Houston, like a hot knife through butter on their first two drives. The Demon defense, absolutely outstanding the rest of the way. Tony?
Brad Laird is going to chat real quick with the end of the CST, and we'll get him here in just a second.
All right, Carly McCord, NSU alumna, is the sideline reporter for CST. But, Tony, what a rally by the Demon defense and the offense that picked it up late in that first half.
Well, what a rally by this entire team,
yeah.
And that's what I'm going to ask Brad Laird about. I know he's got to be super pleased. His team was, frankly, on the verge of being blown out in that first quarter. Came back to take the lead and gave up the touchdown and the safety, but answered with a pick six from Hayden Bourgeois. And telling you what, you're leading the 15th-ranked team in the country here at the half. A great opportunity for Northwestern. Speaking of Carly McCord from Cox Sports Television, her father-in-law is Steve Insminger, the LSU offensive coordinator. I asked her if she had had a chance to talk with him, and before we get to that, we'll talk with Brad Laird. Coach, you were down 14-0 early in this ball game. Offense wasn't clicking, defense was struggling. Your guys came back, and then you gave up 9 points late, and you get a pick six. How proud are you of the resiliency of this team? By the way, you're playing the 15th-ranked team in the country.
Well, and I think that's the thing you look at. Down 14-0 early, our guys battle back, to take the lead, and then, you know, they get the momentum back. We fumble a punt, then we stop them on top of that. They get it first and go back again, and they end up scoring. But then the play right there at the end to make it 28-23, I thought was huge going into halftime, plus we get the football.
At halftime, do you focus on the things that did not go right the first half, or do you accentuate the positive?
Well, there's going to be a combination of both, because we got to correct the mistakes that we made in the first half, and there was plenty. But also understand it's a 60-minute ball game. Our guys knew that before the game started, and we know it now. Just got to get back going in the second half.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Northwestern State University proudly presents celebrating over 100 years of excellence and tradition. The best sounding band in the land, your Spirit of Northwestern Marching Band. Drum majors for the Demon Band are Hope Spa, Michael King, and Brandon Brumelow. Tonight, sit back and enjoy music from Latin America as the Spirit of Northwestern performs hits like Despacito, Havana, and Welcome to Cuba. We'll be right back.
Bank with a location near you, the all-new Legacy Dodge, Chrysler, Ram, and Jeep on the bypass in Natchitoches. Kickoff for the third quarter is on the way. Miles Ward will field this a couple of yards deep in the end zone and take a knee, and the Demons will start at their own 25-yard line. Well, how about these second quarter numbers for the quarterbacks, Tony? Shelton Epler in the second quarter, 6 of 8, 129 yards and 3 touchdowns. Ty Brock, 4 of 15, 36 yards, one touchdown, and one pick six.
And it was Brock who came into this game playing very well the last couple of ball games, and it was Shelton Epler who had struggled the last couple of games.
Absolutely. Demons had come in on a two-game losing streak, while Sam Houston had come in on a two-game winning streak.
Before we get going, George Etheridge, longtime Northwestern State supporter who lives in the Virgin Islands, is listening to us online. Patrick says the game sounds exciting.
Well, the Demons will immediately get an offsides penalty on Sean Mustin, the nose tackle.
Offside, number 92, defense, entering the zone and making contact. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Mustin, the junior from Fontana, California, gets called for the offsides penalty, so the Demons will start first and 5 at their own 30. Three receivers left in a triangle formation, one wide right. That's Jalen Watson. Bryson Bork, Quan Shorts, and Jazz Ferguson are the three in the left side of the formation in that triangle set. Bork in front of Shorts and Ferguson. Epler from the shotgun, looks quickly left, throws the slant, caught by Jazz Ferguson. He's got the first down, and a gain of 9 to the 39-yard line.
Speaking of Jazz Ferguson, who's having an outstanding ball game, mm-hmm. I was talking with wide receivers coach Alvin Slaughter earlier today, and I said, Coach, I know Jazz has been frustrated the last couple of ball games. What have you talked with him about being frustrated? I'll finish that conversation after this play.
Demons all check the sideline as Alvin Slaughter was the only one calling in a play to start with, and now everyone gets going with 11 seconds to snap. Three receivers, triangle formation right this time, one wide left. Epler from the shotgun on first and 10. Outside zone, Stafford Anderson breaks into the clear. He's into Sam Houston territory and down to the 46-yard line.
So Coach Slaughter talked to Jazz about when you're frustrated, you can't let it show, because if you start barking on the field and your body language shows that you're frustrated, that defensive back sees that, and he thinks, I'm in his head, I've got him. So he's really urged Jazz not to show his frustration.
Epler's going to throw the back shoulder fade to Ferguson. A lot of contact, but no call on the far sideline. And incomplete after that 15-yard run by Stafford Anderson. Demons have now run it for 58 yards on 19 carries, just 3.1 yards a carry. But Sam Houston, who had come in averaging 130 yards rushing a game, has just 50 on 18 carries, and they're averaging less than 3 yards a tote. Second and 10 for the Demons at the Sam Houston 46-yard line. Minute gone by in the third quarter. Demons lead 28-23. Three receivers right, one to the left. The three are stacked back into that triangle formation again. Epler looking right, steps and throws to the deep middle. That's intercepted. Not a good throw. Jalen Thomas, the corner, was right in front of Jalen Watson, the wide receiver. And Jalen Thomas stepped right in front and picked that off. His second interception of the year.
Result of the play is an interception. First down, Sam Houston.
Second interception of the ball game thrown by Shelton Epler. So the Demons were into Sam Houston territory and then turned it over on the interception on the deep in cut. They call a dig route, and just not the wise choice there by Shelton Epler. So first and 10 for the Bearcats at their own 25-yard line, basically like a touchback. Brock inside handoff, cutting it back over left tackle and then back to the middle before O'Shea Jackson comes up with a stop. It's a gain of two for Kyron Jackson. Jackson, 12 carries, 47 yards now for the sophomore tailback from Fort Worth. Came in with 317 yards rushing. That's eighth most in the Southland Conference. Three receivers right, tight end to the left. Quick look right, now back to the left. Throws to the middle. The tight end was wide open. And he will go across the 40 to the 43-yard line. That was Woody Brandom making just his fourth catch. But he comes up with it, and it's plenty enough for the first down. First and 10 Bearcats at their own 43. Three receivers right, tight end left again. Brock drops, pressure up the middle. Going to throw to the deep middle. That one's incomplete. Looking for the sliding tight end, Brandom. He could not come up with it. Throw was a little bit low. Brock has struggled. First quarter, he was 11 of 14 for 141 yards, two TDs, one pick. Second quarter, 4 of 15 for 36 yards with one TD and that interception return for touchdown. Three receivers right, tight end to the left again. This is going to be outside zone around the right side. Cutting it up is Kyron Jackson. He'll get right to midfield. And that'll bring up third down and three from there after the gain of seven. By the way, a lot has gone on. We talked about how wild this first half was here. The numbers 3, 4, 6, 10, and 11 teams in the FCS all lost today. And if this holds, the number 15 team in the FCS would lose. Long way to go for that, though. 2 minutes into the second half, and it's 28-23 Demons. Two receivers to either side on third and three from midfield. Brock claps twice, drops, four-man rush. Good pocket. Now it breaks down. Boy, Oioma got held, and the call is there. The flag comes out. Brock runs around the left side and gets good yardage, but there's a flag down and a holding penalty as Oioma absolutely got ripped and turned around 360.
Holding. Number 51, offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay third down.
Matt Burrell, the right tackle, got, again, used like a turnstile by Oioma, the Demon buck end.
Patrick, the fact that you were able to see that reminds me, I've been meaning to ask you something for the past couple of weeks.
All right.
It seems, did I read somewhere correctly where you said that you have never used a pair of binoculars when calling a football game?
You're correct.
Wow.
Never had them, never used them.
You've got bionic man eyesight.
I've got great eyesight, Tony, knock on wood. Oioma in pressure again. Brock steps up into traffic, and down he goes. Jalen Sangster and Zach Krolchik combine on the sack on third and 13, and Sam Houston's going to be forced to punt. Demons get their third sack of the ball game as Zach Krolchik, Jalen Sangster both came up to make the stop after Oioma forced Ty Brock to move up into the pocket. And, Tony, I believe we got some rain falling now.
Indeed we do, which is why I am into my bag and pulling out my rain jacket again.
There you go. Yeah, you can see the rain. When you said it was raining earlier, we couldn't see it up here. But you can definitely see this one. It's raining hard enough. Oh, the Demons almost get the block on that one. That punt a mile high. Bourgeois fields it. He'll bring it up the field, hit a couple of times, and will go down at the 17-yard line. But NSU gets the ball back. After throwing the interception, there is a flag down on the play. We're going to have a holding against the Demon return team. Well, now the weather makes things a little bit interesting for this game. These are two teams that
during the return, illegal block in the back. Number 29 on the return team. At the distance to the goal line. First down.
That's the redshirt freshman Trey Williams guilty of the hold. But, these are a couple of teams that right now are not running the ball effectively. They're relying on the passing game. So you wonder what effect the rain may have. And you couple that with a pretty solid south wind right now. You just wonder, either team that establishes a running game might be the team that wins this thing. 28-23 Demons with 11:48 left to go in the third quarter as the rain starts to fall. Here at Turpin Stadium, Demons have it first and 10 at their own 9. Pistol formation, West behind Epler. West gets the call up the middle, cuts it all the way around to the left side, and he'll be taken down right at the line of scrimmage. Matter of fact, might lose a half a yard. That was free safety Daniel Adams who came all the way up to make that stop, and it will be a loss of a yard back to the 8. Neither team averaging 3 yards a rush in this game. Sam Houston coming in, giving up 190 yards rushing a game. The Demons, 260 a game. Neither team more than 60. Another handoff. This time a great cut in the middle of the hole, and Jared West has the first down. Give him a gain of almost 13 as he made a little jump cut in the hole and then sped right up the middle to get the first down at the 21-yard line. Tremendous job by Jared West, who's run very hard. West last week, 57 yards rushing against Nichols. He's now got 62 in this one. Two receivers right, one to the left. First and 10 at the 21. Another inside handoff. West cuts it over right tackle and surges forward for a gain of 3. So despite the turf toe, Tony, Jared West running very tough.
He is, Patrick. And, you know, the thing about the turf toe is not only is it very painful, but when you think about it, when you're running, you put a lot of pressure on that toe as you try to push off step by step. And I know the equipment folks have made some modifications to the way they wrap his toe and the way it fits in his shoe, and he's really running hard tonight.
Two receivers left, one right. Epler, good time in the pocket, now rolls out to his left, has some room to run. Now he's going to fake, get to the outside. He's turned it up the sideline for the first down and more, and then he gets taken down out of bounds. I thought they were going to throw a flag on that as he was knocked out of bounds. But he kept it around the left side, made a great move on Adrian Contreras, sort of gave him the pump fake. Contreras bit just enough, and that allowed Epler to get around the left side for the first down at the 33-yard line. So first and 10 for the Demons at their own 33 as the clock goes under 10 minutes remaining. Here in the third quarter, NSU leads 28-23. Demons with their second possession of the second half. Pistol formation, two left, one right. To be zone read inside. West picks his way for a yard. Jazz Ferguson comes up limping just a little bit. He seems to be okay, though. He's walking it off on the far sideline. So Northwestern State got down 14-0 in this one. Scored 21 unanswered, gave up a touchdown, then gave up a safety, and then had a pick six to take a 28-23 lead into halftime. Second and 9 from their own 34. Two receivers right, one to the left. Pistol formation, high snap. Epler will get it to West. He'll try the left side, now cuts back to the middle and gets back to the line of scrimmage. And that's all. Snap was a bit high. Epler got it down and got the handoff to Jared West. But no gain on the play. It'll bring up 3rd and 9. The Demons are 4 for 7 on third down conversions tonight.
Pretty good against a team that was very stingy on third down conversions.
Tops in the conference, giving up just 28%. The Demons are over 50%. NSU themselves as an offense, 36% on third down conversions. Three receivers right, two to the left. Nobody in the backfield with Shelton Epler on third and nine from his own 34. Quick drop, quick throw, pass is caught by Quan Shorts. He surges forward but is a yard shy of the first down at the 42-yard line. So you imagine Brad Lair is going to punt here on fourth and a yard from his own 42. Much too early in the game to be thinking about going for this. Quan Shorts is mad. He wanted to go for it. And I imagine Brad Laird has confidence that his offense could pick up a first down in that scenario if needed. But decides to not try it. So Parker Pastorello, who punted two times for a 44-yard average, will again rugby-style punt this one into the wind. It bounces backwards and is downed by the deep snapper, Brandon Eberts, right at the 32-yard line, and we've got a timeout on the field. 7:40 left to go in the third quarter. Demons still lead 28-23. You're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
Thank you to our sponsor, Ivan's Head Furniture, for the
$100 gift card for one lucky winner tonight. Text DEMONS, that's D-E-M-O-N-S, to 40213 for a chance to win a $100 gift card courtesy of Ivan Smith Furniture.
But right now, the powers that be are playing It's Raining Men by the Weather Girls.
Yes.
One of my favorite songs of all time. I'm not going to lie. Every time that song comes on, I crank it to 11 and start getting down. It just, there's something about that song that's tremendous.
Is there dancing allowed in the press box?
I don't know, but I was doing the clap with them and everything. I had the whole thing going up here. By the way, in the upper deck of the press box, the upper deck of the stands, because of the rain, most everyone is retreated under the stands, and they're watching from inside the walkways back underneath the stands, except for one guy. There's literally one person sitting in the stands in a trash bag, it looks like, watching the game from the upper deck. Brock drops, corner blitz comes, he throws to the middle. That one is caught by Tyler Scott. And then we have some late pushing and shoving between Colby Thomas and Obina Ioma. Well, Ioma's been using Thomas like a turnstile most of the game, so not surprised by that. It's a gain of 7 on the play. It'll bring up 2nd and 3 from the 39. Brock, inside handoff over right guard, cuts it to the middle. Now back to the outside to Kyron Jackson. Jackson has the first down and more near midfield. He gets it to the 48-yard line. So a gain of 9 and first down for Sam Houston. 28-23, Demons with the lead. 7:03 left to go in the third quarter. Second possession of the second half for the Bearcats. Brock drops. He's going to throw deep down the left sideline. That one is way over the head. And a late flag comes in. Boy, that is a pretty terrible flag. They're going to call pass interference against Deron Littleton, who was looking at the ball. He had his head back at the ball. And the ball was about 15 yards overthrown.
Defense. 15-yard
and
penalty.
Brad Laird,
first down.
Brad Laird is screaming at our field judge, Dave Kirschman. And I'll tell you what, Tony, that ball, not only was it overthrown, and if it's uncatchable, you can't call pass interference. And Deron Littleton was turned around playing the ball. He wasn't contacting the receiver. An awful call. Brock's going to throw in the middle, and there is no one there. Was looking for Tyler Scott, and that play was all kinds of discombobulated.
We talked just last game about how Brad Laird's demeanor on the sidelines is very calm. It was anything but that time. He took a few steps out onto the field and really let the field judge have it. And Brad's face is beet red right now.
I believe it. Second and 10. Brock drops another late blitz for the Demons. He throws to the middle. That pass is caught just shy of the first down yardage is Tyler Scott. Scott's had a nice day. That's his sixth catch for 69 yards. He leads the receiving corps for the Bearcats right now. Third and a yard from the Demon 28. NSU lined up over the offensive left side. Play action. Brock throws the lob to Davis. No! Can't get the one-handed grab at the one-yard line. And it's fourth and a yard from the 28, and I've got to believe Casey Keeler's going for this.
Northwestern very fortunate there as Deron Littleton was about a couple of steps behind.
Yeah, Davis had the step, but good pressure up the middle of the field forced an errant throw from Ty Brock. So now fourth and a yard from the 28. Bearcats converted their only fourth down attempt earlier. This will be an inside handoff over left tackle. Plenty of running room. Kyron Jackson will turn it down the sideline, and he'll score. So on fourth and a yard, Kyron Jackson gets 28. And Sam Houston takes a 29-28 lead, and they're going to go for two here to try to take a three-point advantage. So Jackson got around the left tackle, cut it to the sideline, and then had nothing but green grass in front of him. So now it's two-point conversion time as Sam Houston will try to take a three-point lead with 6:16 left to go in the third quarter. They're going to run a little swinging gate play. Four linemen to the left side. They're going to bring a man in motion. They're going to roll right wide open underneath is Davion Davis, and he'll cut it up for the touchdown. Well, that was just a trick formation, and the Demons were not ready for it. Actually, Ty Brock had two receivers wide open in the end zone if he wanted them. He had a deep receiver in the back of the end zone, and he had Davion Davis at the five. And both of those guys would have scored the two-point conversion easily. Timeout on the field, 6:16 left to go third quarter. Now 31-28. Sam Houston with the lead on the Demon Sports Network. Huh?
Is proud to support NSU student-athletes. Congratulations to Donovan on this job for being the Stein Superstar of the Game.
Chicken says treat your family and yourself to Southern Classic Chicken in Natchitoches, Manny, and Mansfield. New York Life, let New York Life secure your family's future. New York Life, the company you keep, Nettles Brown, the agent you trust. Drive summary, Sam Houston, six plays, 68 yards. It took a minute 24 off the clock on fourth and a yard. They went around left end with Kyron Jackson for 28 yards and a touchdown. The two-point conversion was good. Ty Brock to Davion Davis. And so Sam Houston takes a three-point lead here, 31-28. Demons are on the road next week, heading north on their way to Conway, Arkansas, to take on the Central Arkansas Bears up at Estes Field, at the ugliest field in all the land.
Patrick, I'm listening to Mike Lucas's chalk talk here on the sidelines, and he told me before the ball game that Northwestern had worked extensively this week on that gate formation that Sam Houston just ran for the two-point play. He told me that they've used that just during the regular offense, not just on a two-point conversion. So he's very disappointed that his defense gave up the two-point conversion. He also made apparently he told his defense something during the last change of possession, and at least one of the players did not do what he told them to do. He's not happy.
Miles Ward will field this one back up to 9 yards deep in the end zone and take a knee, so the Demon offense will start at its own 25-yard line. Well, so far here in the third quarter, the Demons 57 yards, but they threw that interception that stalled their last drive. Tony, I was looking at the quarter-by-quarter numbers, and granted, you have to kind of be careful when you look at those, in large part due to the Texas A&M game. The Demons were down 7-0 going into the second quarter of that one, and then you had the big second quarter for Texas A&M. But Tony, in the second and
play
third quarters,
operator, put the play clock on 25 seconds and start it on my signal, please. Thank you.
So the second and third quarters, the Demons have been outscored a grand total of 118-34 coming into this one. 41-7 in the third quarter. They're being outscored 7-0 right now, or 8-0 actually. Quick slant, great catch by Markeesian Chapman for a gain of 7. We've got an injured Bearcat. That's the nose tackle, Sean Mustin, who'll get up late and limp back towards the line of scrimmage as the Demons are moving quickly on 2nd and 3 from their own 32. Three receivers left, one to the right. Dummy count, and they'll check the sidelines here. By the way, just got an all clear from our weather station. No lightning activity in the last 30 minutes anywhere near. Outside zone run for Stafford Anderson, who finds a nice crease. He's got the first down. He'll take it all the way up to the 43-yard line, a gain of 11. Both teams starting to pick up the run game a little bit.
So you're telling us no lightning in the area, and I can tell you that thankfully the rain has stopped.
Three receivers, triangle formation to the right, one left. First and 10 from their own 43. Now they'll turn and check the sideline. Jazz Ferguson by himself to the left. Markeesian Chapman, Jalen Watson, Bryson Bork to the right. They get the play call, ready to go on first and 10. Epler outside zone to the left side again to Stafford Anderson. This time he loses a yard after picking up 11 around the left side. That one was a loss of a yard.
Patrick, what does that indicate to you, the fact that the third quarter has been a rough one this year?
It's tough to say, Tony. You know, is it adjustments or, the much vaunted second half adjustments? Who knows? Demons are going to hard count and check the sideline. It's tough to say, is it the other team's adjustments are better than yours? You don't know. I think it's a nebulous concept, but certainly the third quarter has been tough for the Demons. Second and 11 from the 42. Quick look left, fade pattern left. Almost a grab by Jazz Ferguson. He nearly had another one-hander as that one was a little bit high for Ferguson, and I think he mistimed his jump a little bit there, Tony. I think if he waited another half second to jump, he catches that one easily.
You know, as dominant as Jazz Ferguson is and can be, receivers coach Alvin Slaughter told me, we're never going to be an offense where we throw Jazz the vast majority of the footballs. We're an offense that's going to spread it around, and he's talked to Jazz about, you just got to be patient because we're going to throw it your way. We're just not going to throw it your way every play.
Third and 11 now, three receivers right, one to the left. Four-man rush under pressure. Epler is going to be slung around and dropped. Another sack given up by the Demons. That is number 4 on the ball game. Coming in, that's half as many as the Demons have had all year long. Demons had been sacked 8 times this season coming in. They've already given up 4 in this one. That one was Fowler, on the other side of Derek Roberson. So Roberson has 3. He's got 8 sacks on the year, and now Fowler picks up 1, and he's got 3.5 on the season. Sam Houston had too many guys on the field. They ran off a player late. That should be illegal participation. You can't have a guy come out inside the numbers and then run off late. No call. Great punt by Parker Pastorello will die at the 20-yard line. Well, you're supposed to not be allowed to run a player on past the numbers to give you 12 on the field and then run a guy off afterward. That's supposed to be illegal participation. Now, it wouldn't have given a first down to the Demons or anything. They faced fourth and forever.
When you think about it, one of Sam Houston's touchdowns came after a muff punt, and that last touchdown came after a very questionable pass interference call.
Absolutely. So first and 10 for the Bearcats at their own 20-yard line after they took a 31-28 lead. Two receivers right, one to the left. Eamon showing blitz. It's going to be a run around the left side away from that blitz into the boundary. And there's a few yards for Kyron Jackson. He'll give him the 23-yard line. Jackson, though, is having a nice day very quietly. 16 carries for 91 yards for him. After that run, he also has a touchdown. Meanwhile, Jared West has 15 carries for 66 yards for the Demons. Second and 7 from the 23. Two receivers right, one to the left. Brock claps once. Now he's going to go talk to his offensive line. Demons are going to check with Mike Lucas. Don't know if he changed a play or not. He gave a signal. Demons are going to blitz. Throw to the outside is caught. Nathan Stewart breaks the first tackle, but not the second. However, it will be out of bounds right at the first down sticks, and they'll give it to him at the 30-yard line. Well, Stewart's been very quiet. That is his first catch in quite a while. First catch of the third quarter, certainly. Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Shotgun for Brock on first and 10 at the 20. He drops, looking to the middle. Throws deep down the left sideline. That one is incomplete, overthrown again, looking for Nathan Stewart. Shamar Bartholomew had good coverage. Or was that Deron Littleton? That was Bartholomew. So second and 10 for Sam Houston. This Demon defense last week, really good against the pass against Nichols, just 118 yards passing for the Colonels, but did give up 299 yards rushing in that one. Just 313 yards of offense right now for Sam. Two receivers right, one to the left. Shotgun for Brock. Big blitz coming from the Demons. He's going to throw the quick outside slant. It's caught. Tackle broken. 40-45 out to the right sideline and out of bounds. Goes Tyler Scott with a big play. The Demons blitzed and played man with no free safety. And they got burned all the way down to the 43-yard line. First and 10 for the Bearcats. Driving in Demon territory. Two receivers to the left. One to the right is Davion Davis. He of the three touchdowns plus a two-point conversion reception in this one. 2.5 left to go in the third quarter. Sam leads 31-28. Ty Brock talking to his offensive line. Now he gets set. Demons show big blitz up the middle again. Quick throw to the outside is at the feet of Tyler Scott. Incomplete as the Demons brought a what they call double A-gap blitz. That means you bring linebackers on either side of the center, between the center and the guard. That's the A-gap. The Demons brought linebackers on either side of the center to force that pressure. It's now second and 10.
Patrick, as I walk through the Demon sideline, I'm cognizant of the fact that we haven't given an injury report tonight. That's good news.
Second and 10 from the 43 of NSU. Three down linemen for the Demons. This is going to be a pitch out to the left side to the receiver, Stewart, and he will, Stewart who went around the left side. He gets about six, maybe seven. They gave him seven. Hayden Bourgeois comes off the field with what appears to be a cramp. There you go, Tony, you jinxed it.
That's me.
He said we haven't given an injury report, and here comes Hayden Bourgeois. And again, it just looks like a cramp. He's just stretching that leg out right now on the sideline. But third and three, Sam Houston 2-for-9 on third downs. Brock, inside handoff over right tackle. Cutting it up is Kyron Jackson, and he's got enough for the first down. Needed three, he got four. For the Demon 32-yard line. Minute 45 left to go in the third quarter as the clock now moves. Demons trail 31-28. They've been outscored in the third quarter 7-0. That makes it all told 48-7. The Demons have been outscored in the third quarter of this year's ball games.
As the rain starts to fall again, FYI.
Two receivers to the right, a couple tight ends to the left. Play action inside. Brock throws it to the sideline and to no one in particular. Brock went down in a heap. Obi Ioma in there. I believe O'Shea Jackson was in there with him. But Brock threw to no one in particular. His inside receiver ran a deep post. The outside receiver just ran a quick check, a hitch at about 8 or 9 yards, and that ball was thrown down the right sideline about 20 yards downfield.
He has not been very accurate tonight.
Second and 10 from the Demon 33. Two receivers to either side. Demons blitz off the left side. Handoff up the middle. Jackson breaks a couple of tackles, tries to get the outside, but Shamar Bartholomew With a great tackle. That was not Jackson, actually. That was Jacoby Butler, the senior from Pearland. Nice tackle by Shamar Bartholomew around the left side. The freshman has an interception in this ball game. Coming in, he played last week and picked up a tackle. This week he's got an interception and a couple of tackles.
When you're a starter on defense in college football as a true freshman, that's pretty impressive.
Third and seven, Demons show pressure again. They bring it right up the middle to Brock. He throws it outside. It's tipped and almost intercepted by Quindarius Whitley, who was covering the back out of the backfield. Jacoby Butler had him absolutely locked up and almost intercepted that swing pass. And that'll bring on the field goal unit. Trey Honstein, the senior from Georgetown, Texas. This will be the first field goal attempt of the ball game for either squad. It will be from 46 yards on the left hash for the right-footed Honstein.
The wind at his back.
Absolutely. Rain falling. Snap is high, hold is good, kick on the way. It has the leg, and it is good. Was kind of rolling sideways a little bit as it got through the uprights, but got through nonetheless, and Sam Houston will take a 34-28 lead over NSU as we have a timeout on the field with 36 seconds left to go in the third quarter. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network.
University Parkway near Interstate 49. Enjoy a clean and fresh Hampton bed and free Wi-Fi and wake up each morning to their free hot breakfast. Hampton Inn and NSU football, a dream team. And a big congratulations to the Pi Kappa Alpha Fraternity. You are the winners of tonight's Cozy's Tailgater of the Game.
Laird, and you've mentioned this before, but he just does a fantastic job of breaking down film for everybody.
He brings the film out and does a great job. As you mentioned, the ball comes off the tee. Drive summary for Sam Houston on that last one. They go 11 plays, 52 yards. It took 3:06 off the clock. Trey Honstein, the 46-yard field goal. And Sam Houston takes a 34-28 lead, and again, Demons now being outscored in the third quarter this year, 51-7. Third quarter has just been brutal for NSU. The good news is they're only down six, so a touchdown and an extra point gives them back the lead. This kickoff, Miles Ward will field 3 yards deep in the end zone and take the knee, and the Demons will start at their own 25-yard line.
And as the rain falls, Patrick, the ball boys on the Northwestern sideline have been instructed to keep those footballs covered. So two of them just walk by me, and you can't even see the footballs they're holding because they have multiple towels wrapped around them. When the rain falls like it is right now, it's imperative that you keep that football as dry as possible.
And remember, in college football, each side supplies their own. It's not like the NFL where there's, you know, one set of footballs that the league supplies. This is a each side has their own football, and so each side trying to keep them dry. Two receivers to either side for the Demons, first and 10 at their own 25. Shelton Epler's now thrown for 259 yards, and the Demons have run for 84. Calls for the football, outside zone to Jared West, cuts it up the left side, and he's got a gain of 2 on the play. Sam Houston now 355 yards of total offense. The Demons have 345 yards of total offense. So game has been pretty close in terms of yardage. Demons have that pick six right at the end of the first half. Sam Houston, Demons don't have to run another play here in the third quarter, and I think they're going to let the third quarter expire as there's 5 seconds remaining. Demons have the pick six. Sam Houston has a safety, so it's been some special teams, or I should say defensive scores for either
that
team.
That is the end of the third quarter.
That'll do it for three. We head to the fourth quarter. Game still very much in doubt. Demons trail 34-28. You're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
Let's take a look at the play of the game, sponsored by Natchez Regional Medical Center.
Nursing and rehabilitation, caring for those you love, located in Winfield. And Jimmy Granger, Natchitoches, Fort Lincoln. Start the fourth quarter. Northwestern State trails 34-28. In that third quarter, Sam Houston put up 128 yards. The Demons, 67 total yards in the third. Three receivers right, one to the left. Sprint out right for Shelton Epler. He's looking. He fires to the sideline. That's a incomplete pass as the ball came out low, intended for Markesian Chapman. Demons had three receivers over there. Quan Shorts running the short out. You had Markesian Chapman running the middle out, and you had, I believe it was LeVar Gums, who was running the deeper out. Chapman was open, but the ball came out a little bit low from Epler. Third down and eight for the Demons at their own 27-yard line. Demons 4 of 9 on third downs. Three receivers right, one to the left again. Epler calls for the football. Four-man rush under pressure. Steps up in the pocket. Flag comes flying in. Epler just throws it away. Well, unless that's something against the defensive line of Sam Houston, this is not good news for the Demons. Also, Timmis Bonner is limping off the field. He is playing hurt. He will have to check out. Jake Gore will come in, the redshirt freshman from Sugar Land, Texas. But
holding, number 57, offense. Penalty is declined.
So the Demons will be forced to punt it away. And the offensive struggles have continued here. Tony, we saw the offense clicking very nicely in the first, really mid to late, really second quarter, I guess you could say. But, man, just have not been able to get anything really sustained here in the third after that one drive that moved down and then they threw a pick.
A lack of consistency.
That's the number one buzzword that Brad Laird has preached, is consistency. So Parker Pastorello will punt with the wind here. He'll get this one away. A beautiful kick. Driving Davion Davis back to the 15-yard line, and he will be met and dropped back at the 10. Tremendous play on that one. The punt goes 58 yards, and the return loses a couple. That is the longest punt of the season for Parker Pastorello. And we have a timeout on the field. A 58-yard punt for Pastorello, beautifully done. And a loss of 3 on the return, so at least the Demons have pinned Sam Houston deep in their own territory. Let's see if the defense can hold it up. 34-28, Sam, you're listening to the Demons Sports Network.
And of course, tonight, our screaming Demon session is the Spirit of Northwestern. Thank you.
22 seconds into the fourth quarter, Northwestern State finds itself down 34-28. All of the scoring in the second half has been from Sam Houston. They have a touchdown, a two-point conversion, and a field goal for 11 points. Two receivers to either side. Brock's going to run quarterback keeper, and he is twisted down after no gain on the play at the 12-yard line. Well, Brock coming in had 119 yards rushing on 26 carries and had a receiving touchdown of 32 yards against Stephen F. Austin, but didn't get anything on that one. Two receivers to either sides. Second and 10. Hand off to Jackson over left tackle. He's got good running room to the outside. He turns it up 25-30 before he's finally ripped down just shy of the 40-yard line by Nick Ford. Up to the 39 goes Kyron Jackson, and he goes well over 100 yards rushing in this one. Last week had 64 yards rushing and a touchdown against Stephen F. Austin. Now 121 yards and a touchdown in this one after that 26-yard gain.
You hate to let Sam Houston out of that hole. If the Demon defense plays a three and out, they've got a great opportunity to flip the field. But now Sam has the football at the 39.
Bearcats running the ball effectively here in the second half. Receiver comes across the formation in motion. Quick drop by Brock. Wants to throw the screen. He does. Wide open spaces, but this is going to be an ineligible man downfield. Jackson will take the sideline, and he will go all the way inside the five, but we're going to have an illegal man downfield against Sam Houston, as that play took so long to develop. You had four linemen about 5 yards downfield, and the ball was caught past the line of scrimmage. If it's caught behind the line of scrimmage, then it's going to be then you can't have an ineligible man downfield.
Personal foul. Hands to the 50 for 33, defense.
Oh, how about that?
At the distance to the goal line.
So everyone, Tony, everyone was walking back to the line of scrimmage. And instead, they get Isaiah Longino with an illegal hands to the face. And so Sam gets the gain on the screen pass all the way to the 5-yard line. And it's first and goal Bearcats, and the Demons are in a world of trouble right now. Well, that sure looked like ineligible receivers downfield. The offensive linemen had released, and because Brock had taken so long to throw the screen, the linemen were downfield. And the throw was past the line of scrimmage, which should be ineligible receivers downfield, but not called. So first and goal, they're going to actually give him the 3-yard line, just inside the three. Receiver goes in motion across the formation. Quick look left for Brock. He throws to the end zone. Davis knocked away. Great defense over there by Deron Littleton.
I'll tell you what Deron Littleton did there, Patrick. His back was to the football, but he was watching the receiver. And when the receiver turned his head and put his hands up, Deron knew that was time to put his hand up. And even though he didn't see the ball, he was able to knock it away.
Well, the Demons desperately need a stop here, down 34-28. You don't want to let Sam get up a pair of scores here. Granted, there's still 13 minutes left to go in the game. Again, the receiver in motion across the formation. Play action. Brock in zone. Touchdown. Davion Davis with his fourth receiving touchdown of the ball game just beat Ian Edwards on an inside slant. And Sam Houston has broken this one open. They lead 40-28. Remember, they started this game up 14-0 before the Demons scored 21 unanswered. And Casey Keeler is going to go for two here to try to make this a 14-point ball game.
Still a lot of time left, though.
13:07, but man, the Demon offense has just not gotten anything going here in the second half. Had 278 yards at halftime. They have just 67 yards in the second half. Meanwhile, Sam Houston, 128 in the third quarter, now 85 in the fourth. Now Brock's going to go out of the backfield in motion. The third quarterback, Schmid, is in. He's going to roll to Brock coming to his right. He's going to throw underneath, and that's a two-point conversion. So all the razzle-dazzle plays coming out on the two-point conversions for Sam Houston. And the Bearcats take a 14-point lead, 42-28. And we've got a timeout on the field. 13:07 left to go in the game. Demons now down 42-28. You're listening to the Demon Sports Network. We'll be right back.
Discover the new student and standard living at Frog Pond Apartments, conveniently located at 3800 University Parkway, across from NSU. Our residents enjoy unique amenities such as a sparkling outdoor pool and spa and a 24-hour fitness center. Frog Pond Apartments is a gated, pet-friendly community offering spacious units equipped with high-speed internet and cable television. The friendly on-site maintenance and leasing staff is happy to assist your needs. Interested in making the leap to a higher standard in student living? Stop by for a tour or call us at 318-357-1300. Frog Pond Apartments, our pond, your pad.
SWEPCO says stay safe and keep away from power lines. Visit SWEPCO.com. French Market Express, University Highway at I-49, home of the Louisiana Yam Cake. And Sheriff Victor Jones, the Natchitoches Parish Sheriff's Office. Northwestern State sees Sam Houston go 5 plays, 88 yards. It took a minute 31 off the clock. Was a 2-yard touchdown pass to Davion Davis, his 4th receiving touchdown of the ball game. Davis only has 68 yards receiving, but 4 touchdowns in this one, giving him now 8 touchdowns on the year. That is the most in the Southland Conference. He and Jazz Ferguson were tied with that mark. Jazz Ferguson has 2 touchdowns on the night, gives him 6 overall, but Davion Davis has 4. So NSU now down 42-28. Still plenty of time with 13:07 remaining, but Tony, the Demons need to find the mojo they had on offense in the second quarter when they put up 175 yards.
And with still 13:07 left, I don't think it's time that you just abandon the run game completely. Still a lot of time left, but you've got to find a way, maybe a couple of big plays. You've got to find something to get Sam Houston back on their heels because their defense feels very comfortable right now.
Absolutely. Meanwhile, Sam Houston State here in the third quarter, they punted on their first possession, but then touchdown, field goal, touchdown. Kickoff 2 yards deep in the end zone. Miles Ward will take a knee. So the Sam Houston offense has gotten going. Again, 2 touchdowns and a field goal in its last 3 possessions. Meanwhile, for the Demons, their last 4 possessions, or their 4 possessions in the second half, interception, punt, punt, punt. Their last 2 possessions total 10 yards. We'll see if the Demons can get something going offensively here.
Stafford Anderson in it running back.
And that's the thing that frustrates you, Tony, and I'm sure frustrates the coaching staff more than us. You see the potential. It's just that buzzword, the consistency that the Demons are trying to get to. 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. Shotgun for Epler on 1st and 10 from the 25. It's going to be zone right. Stafford Anderson, he gets 2. Looked initially like he had a pretty good crease around the right side, but that closed up in a hurry, and he got a couple to bring up 2nd and 8.
Brad Laird likes to talk about when Northwestern plays these ranked teams like Nichols last week, Sam Houston tonight, likely Central Arkansas next week. It's a good barometer of where the Demons are.
Well, they're close. There's no doubt about that. Sprint left for Epler under pressure, and he throws it incomplete before Roberson takes him down. He threw it at the feet of Jalen Watson. Or Quan
no
Shorts, excuse me. Yeah, he threw it at the feet of Quan Shorts, and now the Demons face 3rd down and 8 from their own 27. NSU is 0-for-3 in third downs here in the second half. They're going to go Jazz Ferguson, Bryson Bork, Quan Shorts left. Jalen Watson right. All 3 of the receivers left are in press man coverage right now. There's a safety on either hash. So it's press man with maybe 2 deep behind it. Epler drops. Going to throw the tunnel screen. It's dropped. Jalen Watson had blockers out in front of him.
Incomplete forward pass.
Dropped the tunnel screen, and the Demons will be forced to punt it away yet again.
Shelton Epler is quickly becoming a punching bag for this Sam Houston defense. He is slow to get up. he has taken some massive hits tonight.
Absolutely. Battled through. He keeps grabbing that lower left back as he comes off the field, but he has battled through it. That was just a tunnel screen call. Looked like it was set up well for the Demons, but Jalen Watson dropped it as he was coming. The tunnel screen is where the outside receiver comes back towards the middle of the field, makes the catch, the lineman release in front of him, and try to allow him to get some yardage. This punt will bounce short, take a great forward hop. It'll go inside the 10 and will roll dead at the 5-yard line. A 68-yard punt for Parker Pastorello. Just what the Demons needed to flip the field position. That is his second longest punt of his career, behind a 71-yarder last year. So a 68-yard punt and no return flips the field position, but now the Demon defense has to keep Sam Houston down here and force the punt back. You mentioned the last three possessions, all scores for the Bearcats offensively. Two receivers to either side, first and 10 at the 5. Inside handoff, Jackson hit and dropped. A loss of 2. No, a loss of 3. Back to the 2-yard line. They tried Kyron Jackson over right guard, and he gets up a little bit gimpy. And he'll limp to the sideline and be replaced by Jacoby Butler. Well, now on second down and 13, Demons desperately need to find a way to hold Sam down here at its own 2-yard line and force a punt into the wind. Three receivers right, tight end to the left. Back goes to the left side of Brock as he calls for the football. Inside handoff, huge hole over right tackle. He'll get the 15 in the first down. That is just so defeating for a defense. You have them backed up on second and 13 from the 2, and you give up a run of 15 yards. Clock at 11:25 left to go, and Northwestern State trails 42-28. Demons were up 28-23 at halftime. Sam Houston has scored all the points in the second half, 19 of them. Two receivers right, one left. Quick throw to the middle. That pass is incomplete. Great break on the ball by Ryan Reed, who planted the intended receiver, Tyler Scott, and it's now second and 10.
Not only does Northwestern need the football back, but they need the clock to move slower, which is why having Sam pinned back, if they could have gotten a 3-and-out, that saves time on the clock, and also you would have flipped the field and the Demons offense would have had the ball in good field position.
Yeah, especially since Sam would be punting into that south wind. Two receivers to either side, second and 10 from the 17. Brock. Hands off over the left side. Nothing doing there. Great job, O'Shea Jackson. And Blake Stevenson coming to close that hole. It's a loss of a yard on the run by Jacoby Butler. And it'll bring up third and 11. And here you go. This is the down. You've got to get off the field. Clock moves under 11 minutes remaining. Sam Houston is 3-for-11 on third downs. 1-for-4 here in the second half. Three receivers to the right. Two to the left. Actually, they've got three. Okay, they're moving linemen out. There's a lineman to the right. There's three linemen down in front of Brock. He'll turn and look. He's going to just throw it deep down the left sideline. Has a man wide open, and it is caught. Nathan Stewart right in front of Deron Littleton at the 45-yard line, and a first down on third and 11. They came out with a trick formation. They split out the right tackle, Ty Barrett, wide right.
But that's another formation that the defense has worked on this week. This is not a surprise.
No, they sure looked like a surprise to Deron Littleton, who was in man coverage with Nathan Stewart. Again, Stewart, you know, one of the best receivers in the country. Don't forget that. First and 10 from the 45. This will be a Brock keeping around the left side. He turns the corner, and he's knocked down in Demon territory at the 49-yard line, a gain of 6. As the clock moves under 10 minutes remaining, and Sam Houston is just bleeding this clock drive. Going quickly to the line of scrimmage, looking quickly left, hit as he throws, wide open and over the head of Davion Davis, and that was all Nathalen Nanai coming in and hitting Ty Brock as he threw, because Davion Davis broke wide open up the left sideline. But it was about 10 yards over his head. And that was all Nathalen Nanai on the pressure from the true freshman from Killeen, Texas. Third and five, midfield, another opportunity for the Demons to try to get off the field. They've given up second and 11 and third and long. Third and five here from midfield. Two receivers left, one to the right. Brock's in the shotgun with four to snap it. Receiver in arc motion. Brock drops. He's going to throw it out wide open down the left sideline. Kyron Jackson out of the backfield makes a man miss at the 10 and will go out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Well, they ran the wheel route with Kyron Jackson out of the backfield, and the Demons were unable to locate him. Jackson broke wide open and took it right down to the 5, a 45-yard completion. With that completion, Ty Brock will go nearly to, he'll go right at 375 yards passing. Actually, they gave him 44. So Brock, who had 177 yards at halftime, has nearly 200 yards passing in the second half alone. Two receivers right, one to the left. And whatever adjustments Sam Houston made, they have worked. Brock throws the slant. That one's intercepted by Shamar Bartholomew. Well, there you go. The freshman with his second interception of the ball game, and he gets the turnover trident. Well, that couldn't have come at a more timely.
The play is an interception down to the end zone.
That couldn't have come at a better time, Tony. Again, they tried that same slant pattern with Davion Davis. He's caught a couple of touchdowns on that one. But that time, Shamar Bartholomew undercut him and picked it off, his second interception of the year.
And this game is going to do wonders for Bartholomew's confidence. Remember, he is a true freshman. He made his first start last week. Him coming up with two interceptions, when you're a true freshman, you have a doubt in the back of your mind as to if you can really, if you're really ready to play at this level. Bartholomew is showing us that he is.
First and 10 at the 20 after the touchback. As Epler's going to throw the tunnel screen to Jazz Ferguson, he will go down at the 25-yard line. Tackle made on the play by Zion McCollum, who has an interception of his own off of a broken play tipped pass.
It wouldn't surprise me, Patrick, if Epler starts looking for Jazz quite a bit here, trailing with 8:40 to go in the ball game, down two touchdowns. Well, you need to get the ball into the hands of your best playmaker.
Now, the good news is the Demons, again, down only two scores with 8.5 left. Epler's going to roll right, going to throw to the sideline, caught by Quan Shorts. That could have been targeting as Shorts makes the grab right at the first down marker at the 30-yard line. Epler took another shot from Derek Roberson.
And Shorts took a shot to the head.
Yeah, I thought that might have been targeting. It was head and neck contact over there. Two receivers to either side, first and 10 at the 30. Epler drops under pressure, steps up, wide open pocket, finds his receiver. That's Jalen Watson for a gain of 13 and a first down at the 43-yard line. The good news is, in years past, the Demon offense not designed to make up a 14-point deficit in a hurry. This offense designed to move fast, and they are. First and 10 at the 43. Quan Shorts across the formation in motion. Play action, they're going to throw it out to him in the flat. Now it's just speed, and he will be taken down after a gain of 4 to the 46-yard line. That'll actually give him a gain of 3 to the 46-yard line. So second and 7 for the Demons as Shelton Epler now 285 yards passing in this game. Interestingly enough, and look, this is projecting way into the future, but Epler coming in, 1,328 yards passing. If he averages 280 a game the rest of the way, he'll break the 3,000-yard mark, which has never been done in Demon history. He evades a sack there, throws it out to Bryson Bork. Bork will try to get what he can and then goes down with a loss of a half a yard. So Epler had to avoid a sack in the backfield and then found Bork, his pressure release valve in the right flat, and Bork ends up losing a half a yard. So third down and 8 for the Demons at their own 45. 6:55 remaining, and this is probably four down territory, or depending on where your fourth down is. If it's, you know, fourth and 5 or less, you may go for it here. Down 14 with 6:44 remaining. Three receivers left, one to the right. Jazz Ferguson will come in motion to stack the three receivers to the left side. Epler drops. This time decent protection, though he dances around. Now in trouble, loses the football, gets it back at his own 35-yard line. That is the fifth sack of the ball game. And the problem is, Tony, right now Sam Houston knows you have to throw.
So they're coming after
us. Right, so they don't have any – there's no qualms for Sam Houston. They're not worried about the run at all in this scenario. Up 14 with 7 minutes left, now 6-10. They know that you're not running the football, so they're just pinning their ears back and coming after you, and that is now five sacks. The Demons coming in and giving up just eight all season. They've given up five tonight. That Bearcat defensive front has been very good. Pastorello again with the wind. Another beautiful booming kick will bounce at the 15, go inside the 10 and out of bounds. I think it's going to be right about the 7 or 8 yard line. It will be the 9 yard line. A 56-yard punt. Will credit Parker Pastorello. He has done his job with the wind here in the fourth quarter. He has flipped field position repeatedly. But unfortunately, the Demon defense has not been able to hold that field position. They gave yardage all the way down inside the 10-yard line on the last possession before Shamar Bartholomew came up with his second interception of the game. And the true freshman who coming in started last week and had just one tackle with two interceptions today. He has played very well. 5:48 left and the Demons down 42-28. Expect a lot of run game, and it is. Handoff right up the middle to Kyron Jackson. He gets two to the 11-yard line as Sam Houston will likely be looking to squeeze the rest of the clock out. And boy, if the final ends up right here where it is right now, what a disappointing second half for the Demon offense, which was going great guns in the second quarter. We mentioned 175 yards in the second quarter alone. They have just 67 yards in the third quarter and 17 yards in the fourth quarter. Granted, the sacks are added into that. Handoff to Kyron Jackson up the middle, cuts it back to the right. He's got a ton of running room. 25, 30, 35, and out of bounds he goes at the 37-yard line. Well, Sam Houston's offense, Demons held him to 227 yards at halftime. That run by Kyron Jackson puts them over 550 yards in this game.
The Demons, to have any chance of winning this game, had to get a three and out.
Demons have given up 331 yards in the second half after giving up just 227 in the first half. It's being inside handoff again, over right tackle. This time O'Shea Jackson holds him up before Shamar Bartholomew can come make the stop. No gain on the play. It'll bring up second and 10, but the most important thing in this game is the clock, and it is rolling at 4 minutes and 23 seconds left, and the Demons down 42-28. The boy, Tony, just the disappointment, I think, from being up 28-23 at halftime and getting the ball to start the second half, and you've been outscored in the second half, all told, 19-0.
And then you also think back about the self-inflicted mistakes. The Demons fumbled the ball inside the Sam 5-yard line.
Mm-hmm.
A muffed punt that led to a touchdown.
Handoff Jackson over left tackle. He will cut it up for about five. And Brad Laird's going to go ahead and call his first timeout.
Timeout.
3:47 left
first
to go in this one. And the Demons are down 42-28, and we'll take a timeout. Demons are down 14, need a stop on third and five. When we return, you're listening to the Demon Sports Network. Thank you. Northwestern State's Leesville campus and the West Louisiana Ice Company, all great sponsors of the Demon Sports Network. Well, Northwestern State looking like it will drop its third consecutive Southland Conference contest. The Demons started 2-1, lost to Texas A&M on the road. No surprise there. A&M's played very well this year under Jimbo Fisher in his first year. Then throttled Grambling 34-7, got a 28-0 lead on Lamar at Lamar. Held on with a blocked extra point for a 49-48 win at Lamar. And things seem to be going in the right direction. Demons had scored 34 and 49 in consecutive games. Then at Southeastern Louisiana, the offense took too long to get going. The Demons ultimately fell 24-17. Offense never really got on track last week in a loss to Nichols 28-10. And Demons with a 28-23 lead at halftime. But in the second half, Sam Houston has absolutely exploded offensively, and the Demons have not been able to answer. Handoff up the middle to the tailback, Jacoby Butler, and he will not have enough for the first down. It's a gain of a yard. And so the Demons will force a punt here from Sam Houston. But the fourth quarter alone, Tony, this Sam Houston offense has 208 yards of offense. That's an 800-yard pace, if you will. But in the fourth, so the difference in the fourth quarter, 210 yards of offense for Sam Houston, 17 yards for the Demons in the fourth quarter. And Casey Keeler's going to let the play clock run down to one and call his timeout. Then he'll put his punt team on the field to send it away. But
timeout. Sam Houston, they're first. It will be 30 seconds.
But again, Tony, I don't want to harp on this, but the frustrating part for all of us is we see the potential. You know, the Demons were up 28-23 at halftime. They scored 21 unanswered after getting down 14-0. It's there. It's just not consistent enough yet for this young team and this first-year coaching staff.
So close, but this team is tired of being so close.
Yeah.
They want to win.
Moral victories are not victories, Tony. A moral victory is still 0-1. But at the same time, you've got to really credit. I mean, they are nearly there. Bourgeois is going to call for the fair catch. He's just going to get away from it, and Sam Houston will down it at the 25-yard line as that ball was working against the wind and away from Bourgeois, so he just got out of the way. Well, with 2:57 left, the Demons still have an opportunity, but they're going to have to move exceptionally quickly. You're talking touchdown, onside kick. If the Demons are going to find their way back in this one. Also, not for nothing, Tony, this just sort of some minutia here. Jazz Ferguson's only 5 yards away from 100. If he gets it, he'll tie the record for most 100-yard games in a season. He'll tie Pat Palmer with his fourth. He's got three already and is the leading receiver in the Southland Conference, coming in at 103 yards a game.
I bet Epler looks for him on a long ball somewhere here.
I think
so.
Epler looking right to start. That's away from Ferguson. Throws the slant pattern. That one's caught. First down yardage. I believe that was Markesian Chapman. No, it's Jalen Watson on the reception. So first down yardage for the Demons at the 35-yard line. NSU moving quickly here. 2:44 left to go. One receiver right is Watson, three to the left. Shorts, Ferguson, and Bork. Shorts moves out to wider left. There's the pass complete to Jazz Ferguson. He gets four. So now at 99 yards receiving for Jazz Ferguson on his seventh catch of the ball game. They're only going to give him three on the reception instead, so 98 yards on seven catches. Clock moves at 2:15 remaining. Three receivers, triangle formation left, one to the right. Again, Quan Shorts moves out to wide left. So two in the slot. Epler looking left, throws the slant. There's Jazz Ferguson again, first down yardage into Sam Houston territory at the 45-yard line. So that will give him his fourth 100-yard receiving game of his career and of the season, and that will tie him with Pat Palmer for the most 100-yard receiving games in a single season at four. Pat Palmer set that record in 1996. First and 10, and now a timeout taken by Casey Keeler of Sam Houston. Keeler.
Timeout. Sam Houston.
Unless something strangely miraculous happens for the Demons, Casey Keeler about to win his 50th game as the head coach of Sam Houston, and he's done it in just now his fifth year, which is pretty remarkable. We mentioned he coming in tied for 15th in most victories at the FCS level. He'll actually break the tie for 15th with this win. And if they hold on, it'll be his 224th win in his 25th year. What that tells you, Tony, is he's a guy that's used to winning.
He has a winning tradition. You accentuated it earlier in the broadcast. A successful coach at the Division III level, I believe.
Yeah.
And then
three.
Went to
Rowan College, where he was 88-21-1, five championship appearances in the D3 tournament.
And then went on to Delaware. And was successful.
One title in 2003. And then now at Sam Houston, where he's been to the semifinals of the playoffs three straight years. Epler going to throw deep down the right sideline, looking for Ferguson, who takes a hit after the ball went by. I'm a little surprised that wasn't flagged. Ball had already gone past Ferguson out of bounds, and the safety came over Ernest Harris and laid a little lick on Jazz Ferguson. Not enough to knock him over. Ferguson's a big boy at 6'5", 220. It takes a lot to get him on the ground. But Jazz now 8 catches for 114 yards and 2 touchdowns. Has had a tremendous game.
You brought up the point to head coach Brad Laird during the quarterback club luncheon in Shreveport the other day about Jazz Ferguson's work ethic.
Yeah, he's been a work warrior in practice, but one of the things the Demon coaching staff and Ferguson's going to get the ball, then the ball comes out, they're going to say it's incomplete. It was a 1-yard pass pattern.
Both of the plays, an incomplete pass, third down.
Jazz Ferguson getting up a little slowly. The one thing the coaching staff said, though, is they say when he knows the play is not to his side, when it's to the other side, they said he can sometimes be a little bit lazy on the play. And that's something that Alvin Slaughter has really worked with him to say, hey, you never know. You might be on the opposite side of the field from where the play happens, but a ball could be fumbled, something could happen, and you need to be there. So he, in practice, though, the guy is an absolute warrior. He's out there working scout kickoffs. Shelton Epler's going to throw it deep for Ferguson. Back shoulder, he's got it. Inside the 25, down to the 23-yard line on 3rd and 10. Beautiful throw in on the back shoulder from Jazz to Jazz Ferguson, and he and Zion McCollum are chatting with each other. I don't know, you know, McCollum can point at the scoreboard, but that's about all that Zion McCollum's got in this game right now. Jazz Ferguson has used him pretty good. 138 yards receiving and 2 touchdowns. Minute 31 remaining. Demons are down 42-28. There's fireworks going on in the river right now. They're having a festival down there. Epler looking right, throws into the end zone. That one is incomplete. Was looking for Jalen Watson.
And that pass is incomplete.
Overthrew him. It'll bring up 2nd and 10. But, yeah, the fireworks happening. It's not quite 2014 Louisiana Tech when the fireworks went off right as the Demons kicked the game-winning field goal in Ruston, but the fireworks downtown as there's a festival going on down there. Two receivers to either side on 2nd and 10 from the 22, and Casey Keeler is going to call his last timeout.
Timeout. Sam Houston, their final of the half. It will be 30 seconds.
So that was one of those, hey, let's take a look at what they're doing defensively. I mean, the game's not over. Let's make sure that we mention that. There's a minute 27 left. Demons are down 14. You punch it in the you punch it in before a minute, before the minute goes, or 27 seconds goes off and it goes under a minute, you've still got an opportunity to onside kick and have a shot. But you gotta, again, Tony, we seem to have say this a little bit on repeat the last 3 weeks now, but the Demons don't quit. It's one thing you can say for them. No matter the scenario, they're still going to have the football and still have a chance at it somewhere along the way.
Well, I go back to the first quarter when Northwestern was down 14-0 and not playing very well on either side of the ball against one of the premier teams in the country, and the Demons didn't bat an eye.
By the way, Epler has now thrown for 338 yards in this one. He drops. Under pressure, steps up, throws it shallow to Bryson Bort. Ball comes out incomplete. It'll bring up 3rd down and 10 from the Bearcat 22-yard line. Well, for Sam Houston. They want to pitch a shutout here in the second half. Bearcats have the third best scoring defense in the Southland at 27 points a game. If the Demons could score here, they could get to 35. But NSU needs to find a way to punch it in the end zone. Three receivers to the right, one to the left is Jazz Ferguson, who has a safety right over the top of him, as well as a corner pressed up on him. Not going to let Jazz Ferguson win this one. Slant is caught, great grab. A flag is down as the catch is made inside the 10-yard line on the quick slant to Jalen Watson, but there is a flag at the line of scrimmage. It's either offsides defense or some sort of formation against the offense.
Thrown on the far side?
Yeah, it's offsides on the defense. So the Demons will decline this. It'll be first and goal from the 9.
Number 17, defense. Penalty is declined. First down.
That's cornerback Kashawn Murray, the redshirt freshman from Fort Myers, Florida. So now the Demons will have it first and goal at the 9. Bryson Bork will check out. LeVar Gums will check in. A minute 18 remaining. The Demons are down 42-28. Again, Jazz Ferguson, who's wide left, has a corner pressed on him and a safety over the top of him. Shelton Epler in the gun. First and goal from the 9. Play action. Scrambling out to his right. He's going to just throw it away. Taken down again by Derek Roberson. After Epler throws it away, Epler and Roberson have a few words after that one. And, you know, I'm wondering if Epler might not be directing some of this at head referee Kevin Boitman, thinking that he's not getting protected in some of these occasions.
He's been hit awfully hard.
Yeah,
tonight.
5 sacks all told on Shelton Epler. Demons have now 429 yards of offense. That's basically right at their season average of 425 a game. Three receivers right, one to the left on second and goal from the 9. They're going to run it inside with Jared West, and that's great if you catch him off guard. But didn't catch Sam that off guard. Ball is down at the 6-yard line, and NSU is going to call a timeout. I like the idea because Sam Houston was playing 2 guys over Jazz Ferguson and 5 guys, or really 4 guys over the 3 receiver side. So you know they're not going to have the same numbers that they're used to inside. I mean, you're only going to have 5 guys inside. You figure if you block it up correctly, it could be a touchdown. So I don't mind the idea, but it does force you to call a timeout if you don't make it with a minute 5 remaining. Granted, timeouts aren't really going to matter in this game, Tony, because the Demons are going to have to onside kick if they score this touchdown.
And they need to score it as quickly as possible.
Sure.
To give you enough time to, if you do recover the onside kick, you don't want to be stuck with 6 seconds left and have to throw a Hail Mary. You'd like to have some time to throw a couple of passes downfield.
These two teams have combined for 725 yards of passing in this game. They're approaching 1,000 yards of offense. As a matter of fact, if the Demons put the ball in the end zone, this game will go over 1,000 yards of offense. Right now it's at 997. Demons third and goal from the 6. 2 receivers to either side. Bryson Bork now moves out to the right side. Epler throws it in the middle. Incomplete off the hands of Bryson Bork, who ran an arrow route and outside and then cut it back in, and he was wide open at the goal line. Pass was just a little bit off, I mean a tiny bit off, and Bork couldn't quite adjust to it in time, or else he just walks into the end zone.
You could see him looking back and twisting his body back inside to try to make the adjustment. So would have been a nice catch if he had made it.
So now fourth and goal for the Demons at the 6-yard line. LeVar Gums, the freshman, comes in. He and Quan Shorts go wide right. Jalen Watson and Jazz Ferguson wide left. 5 to snap it. Now Watson across the formation in motion. 2 to snap it. 1, Epler looking right. Throws the slant. Too high, incomplete. Was looking for LeVar Gums. Gums couldn't quite come up with it, and so the Demons will come up empty inside the 10-yard line, and that feels like a familiar refrain from the last couple of weeks. As the Demons struggles in the red zone in their first 2 FCS games, 12 for 13 in the red zone. In their last 2 FCS games, 4 for 12 in the red zone.
Offensive coordinator Brad Smiley telling his offense as they come off the field, good job on that drive and way to fight. The Demons did not roll over, but also did not find the end zone.
So the victory formation now for Sam Houston at their own 6-yard line, and unfortunately will be denied 1,000 yards of offense in this one as Sam Houston will kneel on it. They'll have to kneel one more time, and this ball game will be over. So the Demons will drop their third in a row. They will move to 2-4 overall, 1-3 in Southland Conference play. Meanwhile, Sam Houston will improve to 4-2 overall. They will move to 3-1 in conference play. And Tony, how many undefeated teams are left in the Southland Conference?
How many would that be, Ben?
One. After Incarnate Word lost on that blocked game-winning field goal return for touchdown in Beaumont, McNeese, who is on a bye this week, the only undefeated team left in Southland Conference play. That's in conference play, not overall. They lost to BYU, but that's their only loss of the year. So the Demons played well. Unfortunately, the second half, it was a little too much Sam Houston and not enough Demons. NSU falls 42-28.